Obama's definitely gay. And it like
what?
Since JFK, we've had.
Do you think Biden sucked
his
dick?
We've had two.
I know he's
we've
gay.
We've had two gay. We've had two gay presidents. Since Obama, we've had one straight president, two straight presidents, two gay presidents, and two Andy Dick presidents.
What does that mean?
Really gay.
That would just
that's alcoholic
that
gay.
Will fuck any, like you in Mexico. That would just
right. God damn it.
So JFK and Clinton were both bisexual. George Bush Sr. and Obama gay, and then Jimmy Carter and George Bush Jr. straight.
Dude, my head's
gonna
explode.
Who let a cockatoo in, by the way? Who's made
listen
right
to me.
Now? What animal is made?
It's the only thing that's keeping me from going in the light. Is that fucking weird laugh right now. Please.
Let's bring you back to reality.
I mean, what?
Yeah, baby, we're starting the podcast right now. We're back. You know what, dude? Live. Welcome, everybody, to the show. YKWD. I started the social media podcast. The fact. The YKWD podcast.
YKWD is back again.
Old school, back in the day, where it all started, before them all.
YKWD.
This podcast is so fun and crazy.
It has no rules.
Shut up. You're ruining this.
Where's the bandana, man?
Sorry, it's a comedy podcast. This isn't NPR.
That's what this podcast does.
Is there any better show? This is the original.
What's up, everybody? It's Robert Kelly. We're back with another episode of You Know What, Dude, YKWD at the comedy studio above the world-famous Comedy Cellar. We've been here for a long time, and we're still kicking it here. I got a great show for you today. I'm excited about this show. I've been waiting for this show, and here it is. Max, who's on the show?
We have Sam Tripoli and Andrew Youngblood.
I mean, you really got
Youngblood.
You really got to work on it, Max.
That is the whitest Indian I've ever seen.
I know.
I mean, I lifted it up and went, what do we got? And he goes, Sam Tripoli. And Youngblood.
Dude.
I'm sorry. Yeah. Can we get a voice? Like, you know how they do that? Like, this week, we have Sam Tripoli and Andrew Youngblood. Can we do that? Is there, like, a thing we can get for you? Is there a man modulator?
Yeah, I'll find
just
one.
Have him do a rail right before, and he'll just go full, like, WWF.
I can't mix. Whatever he's taking for his autism, I can't mix. I can't mix those drugs. Here's the problem with these fucking lunatics. They party.
Yeah.
They don't fuck around.
Yeah.
Like, I thought when I took these guys out that they would just be nerds sitting there.
Yeah.
They don't fuck around.
Yeah.
Yeah. Danny, the tall one, the worst of them all face. Yeah.
The worst of them all face.
He gets boxed.
Really?
We got to keep it clean for the first 10 minutes. Anyways, welcome to the show, both of you guys.
Thanks for having me.
I am, I mean, dude, how long have we known each other, brother?
We did a gig. We used to do Beecher's Madhouse together back in Vegas. The greatest hell gig of all time. It was war. Like, you would walk out to sound, but it paid phenomenal.
Here's the thing. It was the worst gig on paper.
Yeah.
Ever. And in life.
Yeah.
I mean, both.
You could feel sound when you walk out. That's how loud and crazy it was. You could feel the sound.
It was at the Hard Rock Hotel at the peak of the Hard Rock.
Yeah.
Right? I mean, when it was, I mean, good times.
Yeah.
When chicks were sluts and guys were pigs.
And you could enjoy the sluts.
You could, I mean, yes. They were into it.
Yeah.
100%. We were all into being, we were all in the early aughts, late 90s.
Yeah, yeah.
We were all like, dude, AIDS is gone.
Yeah.
We can. It was like almost after the pandemic when people would just took their masks off and started being together again.
100%.
Except we just started banging.
Yeah.
And it was fun. And
condom stock prices just.
Nobody
using them anymore.
You started pulling out like it was 79.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Yeah. Maybe just risk it all.
It was so great.
Hope she didn't want a kid.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? It's at the Hard Rock. And he would fly you in on, I think, Wednesdays.
Yeah.
The show is Saturday, and you had to do 15 minutes. Saturday show, 15 minutes.
3 days are there?
Because it was a buildup of just anarchy, partying.
Chaos. Midgets.
Yep.
African dancers.
Yep.
Topless. I mean, dude.
Strongmen. There was just a guy balancing a moped on his chin.
Yeah, dude. It was crazy. And then it's like, come out and do stand-up. Like, just an assault on your senses and then quiet, listen to me talk.
Wait, all those things are real things that were there.
100%.
The show,
I thought this was all, you guys were just, yeah, I'm like, I don't know what the
2,500
hell
seat theater.
Jeez.
Packed with,
yeah,
I don't know what generation that was. The best.
Yeah.
They say World War II was the best generation.
No.
1980 to 2005.
Yeah.
Whatever generation that
we were
was,
blessed.
They
we were
the best.
Yes. We were blessed.
I mean, those guys fought a war.
Yeah.
But we did bang.
Yeah. Dude.
We had fun, man.
Yeah.
No one was offended.
We set high scores.
We set high scores and nobody cared.
Yeah.
There was no one was getting report. I mean, dude.
Dude, the pickup lines back then would be felonies today. But
yeah,
this whole show,
how you talk to
that were like how to pick up
ringing doorbells.
Yeah,
there was like that pickup artist show that was just like on like regular TV.
Yeah,
and guys would watch it and they're like, "This is how you get sluts."
Yeah,
it was fucking ridiculous.
Yeah, 100%, dude.
It was great.
You go into the show. I remember going to the show for the first night on Saturday, and there was a. I mean, they had a fake breast competition. So they would have all these girls that go up there with just awful tits who needed fake tits.
Yeah.
Like a double mastectomy.
Yeah.
And they'd have a chick with just saggy tits, and they'd go up on stage and pull their tits out, and the place would go nuts. They had a stripper table. They had a hooker table.
Yep.
They had a famous people
table.
They had
the swingers. All the Vegas swingers would show up.
Right.
And then if you got lucky, it was great. And you know who enjoyed it? Women.
It was mainly women.
How weird it got. And
yeah,
everyone...
Britney Spears was there.
Yeah.
Paris Hilton was there.
That was like the best thing I've ever heard of.
It was the greatest. But dude, when you walked out, I remember one time Beecher had me come out. And I don't know if it was with you, but E! Entertainment News was there.
Yeah.
And this is a true story. I'm about to go up. They're like, hold on. Paris Hilton wants to go out. And I'm like, what? You're going to have me fall, Paris? And dude, this was at the height of her power.
Yeah.
And dude, she walked out and you think Nelson Mandela just got released from prison.
Yeah.
The place went nuts. She's like, and she was just like, isn't this great? I love Beecher. And she just would do that. And then she got done. They're like, now Sam Tripoli. And I walk out, dude. And this was it, man. I would just start doing jokes and nothing. And then it would just, like, I started getting a couple boos. And I'm like, I'm about to bomb here. So they always told me the key to the show is getting the women behind you.
Yeah.
So I bail on my act. I'm like, dude, how hot are the women? Give it up for the lady. And it goes from me getting booed, I get a standing O. I walk off stage, you're like, we've never seen that before.
Yeah.
Once the boo birds come, it's fucking over. And I saved myself, dude.
It was, let me tell you something. It was the most nerve-wracking show.
Crazy.
And I knew who was going to bomb. Because I performed with a couple of people, and they were calm. They were like, it's a regular show. They were just chilling in the green room, having drinks, having giggles, blowing their load. Blowing the load, and I'd be back there like
dead,
like dead Creed, sweating. I had Vaseline on my eyes, and because I knew once you went out there, if you bombed, you weren't coming. It was a catch 22. It's like you never wanted to go back, but you wanted to be back, because of the craziness that would happen. I was there one night, and it's a circle bar, so everything's in a circle.
Yeah.
So it's just the smokinest people, humans, just circling.
Yeah.
Like, and they had a drum kit. I think it was from The Who. It was Moon's drum kit.
Yeah.
And this long haired dude just went like this. Woo! Took out sticks, jumped on the kit. The place is going. And then he just jumped off and ran through the crowd. And everybody protected him because the security was coming and they just blocked security. It was crazy shit,
dude,
like that.
This is how funny this guy is. He just blew out his tendons on Torgasm.
Yeah.
And then you went up with one leg and you still freaking crushed. I remember that. I'm like, wow,
that's
a funny guy.
You had to get the chicks.
Yeah.
You're right. You had to get the girls because it was just tables of the worst type of girl to get. Smoking hot. Smoking hot Vegas girls who are there to party and get laid. They have the attention span of a hummingbird.
Yeah.
And dude, but if you got them, if you said one thing, you were in, and they were like, "Fucking, I want him." And then you go to the part. Fuck the show.
Yeah. Oh yeah, downstairs,
dude.
The best,
dude. Let me tell you something. So after, at the end of the show, hopefully you killed. You have to come back out on the show.
Yeah.
And all the dancers,
yeah,
the Beecher dancers, which were smoking.
Yeah.
They would come out, and you'd just be dancing with all these half-naked girls. Things would be falling, and then you went to this party on Saturday night. Let me tell you something. You didn't leave till Monday.
Wow.
You had to stay Sunday, because Sunday was the pool day, and it was the craziest, probably the craziest time in sobriety, where I was like, I think I'm drinking. This is the same feeling I have.
Well, you were sober that far.
Dude, I was sober since I've been 15. But at that point, I'm like, this feels like I'm drinking and using a lot of drugs. Like, I remember going back to my room on Saturday night, like 5, and be like, I relapsed.
Yeah,
this is technically a relapse. What I just saw and did,
yeah,
is a relapse. I should start my dates over again.
I remember when I first got sober and I would go out and I'd be like, oh, I'm not going to drink, but I'm going to pound 1,000 Red Bulls. And then the next day, my head was flighty and all this stuff. But I remember doing the show, and I used to have a joke about it where it's like, you know, you're trying to get laid and you're like, you're going all night, none's happening. And then literally this happened to me. I was about to walk out and this one girl stops me and she says the three most amazing, oh my God, you were in the show. You were so funny. And then I can't find my friends. I'm like, boom! Let's go, bro! Hail Mary pass, touchdown.
It was like hitting a jackpot.
Yeah, right there.
Like ding, ding, ding.
That was it, dude. It was crazy.
I remember I had some of the, because it was, he had the same crew. It had to be like
Steve Burns,
Sherrod,
Brian Callen,
Dov Davidoff.
Yeah.
It was a certain type of dude that could muscle that room. I remember one time Steve Burns did the funniest thing ever, because he would come out and he had a trick where he would go, hey, what's up, everybody on this side of the room? You guys, he did the rock shit, like the wrestler. What about you guys? These guys are a little better, right? I don't know, you got it? The place is going fucking nuts.
Steve Byrne is savage.
He's savage, but he fucked up one night because he got so into it, he ran out into the crowd. And the place is going, and he went too far back. So it was like, he had to walk like a half an hour in silence and then roll back up on stage because there was no fucking, so he had to like jump and roll. And it was like, what's up? And it was like dead. It ruined. I was like, oh shit. I was dying upstairs.
Now, here's the funniest thing. So he would have like, he started maybe with 4 comics, right? And then one comic would bomb so bad, he would go down to 3 comics.
Yep.
Then a comic would bomb so bad, he'd go down to 2 comics.
Yeah.
And the one comic that was hilarious, because I remember the story, was when Bill Burr did Beecher's Madhouse.
I was there.
He went there and he opens up about futons.
Yep.
About sleeping. This is how long ago Bill Burr's still doing futon joke at this rock party, and everyone's just like, "Bill!" And you know, Bill won't get off stage. He's like, "I'm doing my fucking time." Yeah, right?
He doesn't give a fuck. That's when Bill Burr, I think that show, when he was like, "I'm done. I'm not taking shit from these fuckers," and he built up a dossier on everybody in every town, in every city. He has something on anybody. So if that happens again, fucking Vegas, you fucking bad Paris Hilton, and would annihilate everybody. That I remember that show. I was on that show. I was there. There was a couple people that took a hot one, and I felt bad because it wasn't them. It was just
crazy.
You had to grab the wheel of the bus and just drive it. It wasn't about comedy. It was about survival.
Yes.
And the payoff after. And to be a single dude, I hope I was single. Let's date this. Yeah, single before my wife. Okay. Anyways, I was a piece of shit back then. She knows.
Yeah.
I'm done now.
We're
different.
Yeah.
And so could you imagine? Like, we were at a casino this weekend. I went to my room.
I think love going to bed. I did that last night. I was like, we had a him and I run the dojo, and we have a we had a black award show last night, and
I'm sorry,
nobody
what?
Got shot. It was great.
A black a what?
It's a black award show.
You too?
Yeah.
Two white guys.
It was called the Grifters, and okay. It was just me and black people. It was awesome. Nobody got shot. We were nice. All super happy.
It's great.
Yeah, dude.
What were the awards for?
It was these guys give awards for people who try to grift off the internet. It was really funny. Oh, and it's funny. Amazing how many people win a grifty and come and accept their fucking.
That's hilarious.
Yeah, it was funny.
What's a good grift?
What were some of the grifts? The People's Grift, Grifter of the Year.
What they do?
Sports like, Grifter. Sports Grifter was great.
What's
was,
a sports grifter? What
it
is
was
this?
Like, it's like Travis Kelce, and it's like, oh my God, he's like takes 20 mil to push on Pfizer on everybody. Then he's making out with that fucking 4x4 Taylor Swift, dude. Like, this guy only bangs like futuristic blacks, and now he's doing the flattest ass you've ever seen in your life.
Yeah, it's pretty weird.
Am I losing everybody?
No, right?
He's just so a room full of Swifties.
He's
for the Beastie Boys. You got the beat up boys over there.
He's changed so much. Like, his early like interviews were always so funny. He was literally wearing a durag, like speaking in a black scent, and now he's like marketed to everybody.
Dude, he's full wigger, crazy. And now he's dating the whitest chick you've ever seen in your life.
Pretty wild.
I was just watching this weekend. Danny, what was that guy? Dutsky? The black dude with the beard?
I don't remember the name.
Okay, I'm going to tell you this guy. Do you know this guy? This has got to be some type of grift, dude. It's if it's not, it's Drewski.
Drewski.
That guy. You know that guy?
Oh, yeah.
Buddy, you know him? I'm sorry.
I've seen his face before.
Okay, yeah, dude. Yeah.
He's been a million commercials.
Dude, he's got a show.
Yeah.
Where he's like kind of like records.
Yeah.
Something like, bring it up real quick. Dude, he basically bringing people in, and it's like
I've seen it.
This chick comes in, and she's big black chick, big titty. Yeah. He's like, you got OnlyFans? She's like, yeah. How many times you on there? Every day. You're on the show.
Yeah.
You're in. Sign this paper, but I'm gonna DM you through your OnlyFans. That's how we're gonna connect. Yeah. He just hooks into her DMs on her OnlyFans. So then this other chick comes in. He's like, "Yo, you what's up?" She's hot. He's like, "You got an OnlyFans?" She goes, "No." He goes, "Get the fuck out! Get the fuck out! Get this bitch out of here, dude! I don't know how this is on TV,
dude. I love it. Black people have superpowers.
They do, right?
Because black people are kryptonite to white feminists. They can't say anything
can't
to them.
Can't say nothing.
Because the only thing worse than sexism is calling a white woman a racist.
Yep.
That is like their kryptonite, and they just scatter like a cockroach just when the light comes on. Yeah. So they, dude, I love watching black YouTube. Do you ever watch black YouTube?
What is black? Yeah, stop.
That's not
stop.
Like a whole nother website.
Is no, that, it's just the part of YouTube that's just black content creators.
Am I going to get flagged by the FBI?
No.
I'm not going to be on a list, am I?
No, you're already on a list.
Am I?
Yeah. We're all on list, dude.
What are you talking about?
Everybody's on a list.
What list am I on?
Yeah. You're on a shit-talking list.
Am I on a list?
Yeah.
Can I ask you a question?
Yeah.
I know. I'm going to get back to this black YouTube
But what
thing.
I want to talk about is Houston Comedy Club, too, because it's fucking fire. Have you played his club?
No, he hasn't.
Oh, it's fucking fire, dude.
What club is it?
Houston.
I'm in Houston coming up.
Yeah. We're on the same festival, weirdly enough.
We're on the same festival.
What's the festival?
The Riot Festival.
Oh, the one I never get invited to? I only do Skank Fest. No one else will let me dance.
In fairness, they only do
that. This is about me. I'm not in his club. Okay. We're on the same fest. He's on my podcast. I've never been invited.
You got to go.
We're on a list.
It's crazy.
We're on a fucking list.
We're on a fucking list, dude.
He's got us on a list.
No, yeah. I'm not the man. Listen, this is it's a comedy club owned by four comics. So throwing that, I'm not like a rich.
What's the name
I'm
of
a broke
it?
Asshole. The Secret Group.
The Secret
Group. Oh, dude, exactly. I've heard about that.
Yeah, we'd love to have you anytime.
Secret Group is great, man. Danny, you told me about that, right?
Have you played the Seeker Group?
No, I've
Autistic
never
played
there. Too? What am I talking about?
I've never played there. The Seeker Group?
Are you listening to your own show?
Are you falling apart? Did his batteries come out?
Robot needs a big
dude. Plug him in. What the fuck?
No,
I'm sorry, Danny. Stop. Don't even answer. Get your shit together. I'll come back.
Listen, I love Houston. I would power rank the cities in Texas. I would play Houston
because
it's got the hottest futuristic black chicks. Number one.
We're a pretty diverse city, so you get a
no,
whole...
there's a lot of hot black.
What's a futuristic black?
They're is just that like a hot blacks.
Is that a black chick who's into like Star Trek?
Maybe, but they're just, they look like they're from the future.
Really?
They're so shiny and hot.
Shiny and hot.
Smell good.
I don't think I see them in Houston.
They're all over Houston.
I don't know. I'm blinded by all the Mexicans. I love, I just, well, Mexican.
Latina chicks are the only ones
I'm on a list because of this show.
Are we not allowed to talk about this?
Yeah. We're saying good things. I think it's fine.
I'm pro-black.
Yeah, and I'm pro-Mexican. Yeah,
I'm pro. I can't say. Yeah, I'm pro white.
Yeah,
I like white
I'm
people.
Pro white too. White
can you say white, white people too? Yeah. Are we Me Too at this point? White
no,
people
we're,
too.
Dude, Me Too's dead.
Yeah, I don't know.
It's not. Trust me.
It's not.
Nah.
I'm
Let's test it. Danny, go grab a tit out front.
Yeah. go tweak a nipple.
Yeah, go tweak a nip and take your
I'm
dick
autistic.
Out.
I'm autistic.
So you all right? Listen, I want to get back to something. Okay. To you. Yeah. Fuck, I had a thought. You went over to the Houston
club.
Sorry,
dude.
Really? It's all right.
Love his club.
All right, I love your club, too. What's the name
please
of it again?
The Secret Group. Please
I guess
come.
I'm not invited. Me
no,
either.
You're welcome.
Dude, you're doing
anytime.
Festivals. I get nothing but Skankfest.
Dude.
And I love Skankfest.
Can I just say something to you? There's no more festivals. Skankfest is the only one.
Yeah, and now Montreal went.
It's gone.
Because, and the only reason people went to Montreal is because you can get LA 10 hookers for $50.
What
That's the only reason.
What are you talking about?
There is high-end hookers. At the Montreal Comedy Festival.
$50 American or Canadian?
$50 American.
Okay, that's a different thing. That's like $20 more.
True.
Well, for a 10?
For a 10? Yeah. A 10? A Canadian
10? Have you ever like been on Chatterbait? Am I the only scumbag here that's ever been on Chatterbait?
What's Chatterbait?
Chatterbait's those webcam things.
Are you married?
I'm familiar.
Well, I've been with my girlfriend 20 years.
That's funny. I don't know what the fuck that means. Is that L.A. marriage?
Yeah. We're good. We're good.
That's the way gay guys used to be. I've been with him for 30 years.
Yeah. Well,
is that your husband? We've been together
listen,
20 years.
I would get married. I always make the joke that I wish I would have married her because I could have gotten divorced by now. You know what I'm saying? Right? But it's like in my family, it's just everyone who's ever got married, it's been crash and burn. So I told her, if you want to stay together, we can't get married.
Right, but let me ask, but you guys are in love, right?
Yeah, I love her.
You guys are together.
She drives me fucking nuts.
Okay, of course, dude, that's married.
Right? I'm in love. She's older than me.
Dude, I saw my wife today. I was so happy to see her, and she went, yeah.
Yeah.
What? I went, hi. Hi, buddy. I miss you so much, baby. Yeah. Do me a favor. Get me that pan out of that drawer. I was like, I wanted to hit her with the fucking pan. I mean, that's marriage.
Is that considered domestic violence, or is that just working it out?
No, I always said you can see how happy a marriage is if you look on the fridge and there's a bunch of dents on it, and if you put her and it goes right around her head. That's a good marriage.
Yeah, that is.
Yeah.
I think you make it to 20 years, it's not domestic violence. It's just working it out.
Here's the problem with my wife. She'd probably fight me, and there's a chance she could win, and I don't want that out there.
Do you have any fighting skills at all?
I do have fighting skills. But my wife had three older brothers that were like 6'4" that used to beat the shit out of her so she can take a beating.
Oh, shit.
You know what I mean? My fear is I'll crack her, she'll go down, and then she'll just get back up and keep
She's
coming like the
Terminator.
And then just cuts my dick off.
Yeah.
And walks out with a bloody nose and a black eye. You want to fuck with me, you cocksucker?
Yeah.
Because she's from Boston. You ever hit a woman?
Oh. I probably hit my sister when we were kids, but that's about it. Yeah,
thanks for your honesty.
Yeah, you know.
That was a heat check. You're in.
Yeah. Are you mad?
No, I'm divorced. I made it 3 years. That's it. That's all I could do, and I got the fuck out.
You
I couldn't do
great,
it.
Bro.
And you still friends with her?
No. Oh, God. We, like, it's crazy. It was one of those things where we, like, were very similar, and then when we got divorced, we just went opposite. Like, she married like a guy who's the exact opposite of
what is
me.
That? Black and bald?
No, that'd be great. But no, just some like weird tech guy who's like nerdy and stable and a normal life and fucking doesn't
Can
like
I stop
to do
you right
anything.
There? Not the exact opposite of you.
Okay. All right.
Dante Nero, exact opposite of you.
Yeah.
Okay. Saying?
All right.
But that guy's. Close.
You look like you can give a TED talk on AI. That's what dude. You look like. You look like
I'm stupid as
You
far.
Look like you
know.
Just came out with a new fly rod.
Yeah. I only wear black because I think it's slimming.
Yeah.
It's not fooling anybody.
Those buttons are working, right?
Yeah, for sure. For sure.
The exact opposite of me. He's a tech guy.
All right, fine. But I hated it. I was. Sorry. No, you're good.
No, sorry, dude. We both fucking had zings right away.
Oh, you're good.
No. Oh, I'm sorry, dude. I have fucking more, and I'm holding them back.
Check out his special.
Check it out. You got a new special on. Get that out in the middle. What's it called?
I'll tell you this.
I don't like that you're a better host than me.
It's coming out.
I have 8 podcasts.
Dude, I have fucking 15.
Yeah.
It's coming out March 28th on Mark Norman's YouTube. So
who's that? Right. Who's Mark Norman?
You know, just a short gay. You met him.
Oh, yeah.
Short
gay guy. He's with the other tall
guys. Those are the aliens. The short gays and the short gray.
Yeah. All those guys are gay. That would be happy. I would be so happy if they're all fucking each other.
Yeah.
They're all sucking Shane's dick.
I wonder what retard dick tastes like.
Strong, maybe? Yeah. I don't know.
Tastes like, I'll tell you what it tastes like. It tastes like ashes and pennies.
Oh, fun.
Yeah. You ever watch that Down for Love show?
Yep.
Because there's the autistic one, which is Love on a Spectrum, which is very wholesome and like sweet, right? And they're like, I want to find. Oh. They're like, I want to find true love, and then you're like, oh, this is kind of adorable. Yeah. And then there's Down for Love, and they do the one-on-ones, and they're like, I'd like to find a girlfriend and sex. And you're like, this is so funny.
Well, I live
just Down syndrome, being like, I want to fuck these people.
Dude, the Downs are leveling up, bro. I've never seen Downs more powerful than ever. They're like Victoria's Secret.
I lived with 6 Down syndrome elderly men.
What?
When I started comedy.
What's elderly? Like 25?
50 and up.
How does that even. Yeah.
They're like dogs?
Yeah.
I was quick. What's up? Give me that sucker. They were like 50 and up.
Oh, snap.
They were close.
I didn't know they lived that long.
They do. I mean, I was at the end, but I lived with 6 of them in a house. A three family house, regular family on the top floor.
Yeah.
3 on the bottom.
Yeah.
3 on the second floor with me, had my own little apartment, and I got free food, $100 a month. I just had to be there from on Monday to Friday from 11 at night to 8 in the morning. So I did the overnight. I had to make sure they didn't get up and fucking, you know, do weird shit. But I found out very soon into living with them that they have the same sex drive as us.
Oh yeah.
But they don't have gay or straight. They want to cumsies.
Yeah.
They want to cumsies. Yeah.
Hole's a hole.
But they don't care. So my first week there, I at night, Barry, Down syndrome, you know, long tongue, bald, right? You know, greatest guy ever.
Kind of like this?
Worse.
Okay.
Pot belly.
Okay.
Me 2 years ago. But all of a sudden, I heard bam, 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 and I woke up because I'm my first week of the job. I'm like, oh my god, he needs me.
Yeah,
something's happening.
Yeah,
and I ran into him. Barry, what's wrong? He was jerking off to me. He's going bam, bam. He goes, get out, bam, get out now. Nah. He starts laughing. He's like, ah, he's just jerking and going, ha ha ha. Dude, I was in horror. I called my boss. I'm like, he was saying my name. Oh no, no, she told me. They don't think
that means they like you.
That means they like me, right? Exactly. But they knew what they were doing. I would bring girls back, and I didn't tell them that. I just told them I had weird roommates. I wouldn't tell them that they were retarded, right? Mentally retarded. So, dude, these girls would come in, and at that point, when they like you, they mimic
smell
you.
It?
They mimic you. So I used to wear like bikini underwear because I was smoking hot Bobby back then. So when they got their clothing vouchers, they bought the same underwear as me. So they would wear it. So I'm sitting there, I bring this chick back, and she comes up, and you know, that quiet, like, you know, oh, this is nice. All of a sudden, Barry comes out with just bikini blue underwear. Bam! Bam! And you can't even see his just guts just hanging
that
up his back.
So hilarious.
And he walks up and he goes, ah! And she's like, hi. I'm like, these are my roommates. And he comes up and grabs her and puts his hand on her ass. And she's like, ooh. And I'm like, Barry. He's like, sorry. And he looked at me and goes, he knew exactly what he was doing. He knew exactly what he was doing. He went and grabbed her ass and he used him being retarded. As she's like, it's okay. It's all right. Let him do what he wants. Oh, dude. Yeah.
Imagine Me Too and a special person. Imagine that, dude.
That's wild.
I mean, you could.
Yeah. They do enough wrong.
Dude.
They're eventually going to take it.
I was there.
You got to play dead. That's what I've learned. Play dead. They get turned off by.
What do you mean play dead?
Like they're always they got that.
You just
that
stop special, moving.
Yeah,
if they're coming, you just
like
drop
dead. They're like,
wait a minute.
They're not in the
mentally retarded people.
They're not bears. They're that's crazy.
They come in. Ah, my da. Oh no, no. Nah, no, 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 no. They just walk
they move
off.
On. They move on. They're like apex predators. Dog. You gotta play that.
That's so fucked up. Oh, cut me out of that clip. I tell you what, me and Billy Burr and Patrice, when I was leaving, I did a show for them, and they came. And let me tell you something. The guy didn't have a microphone, so we had a lavalier. I just remember Patrice being so mad at me. He was mad at me two times in my life, violently mad. One for putting him on that show. He was holding a lavalier. He's going, hello. Just rows of mentally retarded people. Ha! I'm going to kill you, Bob.
That's crazy.
And then the other time was Marco Island. Remember that game?
Oh.
No, man, he called me up. He goes, yo, Bobby, next time you see me, I want you to run. I'm like, why? He goes, because you told me this gig at Marco Island was a good gig.
Oh, the,
and he goes, I'm
Captain Brian.
He goes, I performed in front of two Mexicans cooking halibut. I can see them cooking fish, you motherfucker. I'm gonna hit you with a pipe. I'm fucking coming after you. He just hung up. He was mad at me for like 2 months.
One time Captain Brian had me bring my naughty show out there, which was like this multimedia adult film star comedy show, and I brought Tara Patrick, and the entire swinging population of Marco Island showed up.
My God.
And it was the former mayor was like the leader of the tribe.
Yeah.
And it was just a bunch of 40-year-old chicks with Nazi helmet tits. You're like, you're 40, your tits should be down here. They're all like anti-gravitational. That's how you know they're swingers.
I love
it. They have anti-gravitational tits.
Yeah, and they have the cancer freckles.
Yeah.
Right? They're going to have some of that removed. In a couple,
for
right?
Sure.
They have little band-aids up here from having like a nugget taken off.
Yeah.
I'm interested. So I your Twitter is one of my favorite Twitters.
Really? Thank you. I love the Jews tweet.
And I'm here's why.
I love them.
You put the most interesting shit out there.
That's a nice term for it.
And it's and you put these little things on top of it that are always trying to be funny. It's never really like, dude, we're fucking world's ending. You better get your shit together and get snacks. It's a little fuck you.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Which I like that.
Thanks. It's why
I like Jon Stewart. He's funny with it.
Right.
He's talking about the shit. You know what side he's on.
Right.
But he's always zinging everybody, and he's always like, he was talking about the border crisis, and he was talking about, and they showed all the people. There's Iranians. There's Syrians. There's military men coming up from China, and then it just cuts back to John like, all of them are. There has to be a few podcasters coming in.
it's just exactly.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Brilliantly funny.
Yeah.
Makes everybody laugh.
A spoonful of sugar.
Right, but are you a fan of his?
Of his?
Yeah. I've been friends for a while.
Of his Twitter?
I don't follow his own. I don't do Twitter. I got off of it.
Why?
Yeah.
I'm not good. I hate it. It's fucking exhausting. I do the other bullshit. I do Instagram and
your Snapchat, right? That's what
no.
Like if you I ever wanted to dominate like, comedy, go on Snapchat.
I thought Snapchat was just for like
dude,
sending.
Snapchat is comedy done by Russian sex trafficking victims.
This is why I love it, dude. I mean, is it true? Is it not true?
Have you watched how bad the comedy is on Snapchat?
I didn't know people watch comedy on Snapchat at all.
Yeah, they got it. It's kind of like a smokescreen for all the.
I thought Snapchat was to cheat on your wife.
That's what I thought it was
but
for.
But they got to present it. That was the funniest part about Whitney Cummings trying to bring comedy to like OnlyFans, you're like, nobody's gonna go there for comedy.
Yeah, it's pretty nuts.
What are you gonna tell your wife?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm watching comedy. Right?
Yeah, but then why does that girl have a dick?
Yeah.
Not Whitney Cummings. Not anymore.
So,
we know that for a fact now.
I heard the reason why OnlyFans is doing the comedy thing now is because they were getting in trouble with the banks, and the banks weren't taking their checks or something because it was a porn company. So now they're throwing hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of thousands of dollars into comedy so they can tell the banks, Now we're a media company.
I guess his computer's working again.
Yeah.
Holy shit. That was a long...
Fun fact from the insightful.
Office. Fucking AI. Yeah. I heard that they were using comedy again.
AI, why is OnlyFans doing comedy? I have heard that banks...
The banks have taken... His, I don't do Twitter either. I'm not good at it.
I'm not good at that. Because I'm not against it.
I don't. I have dyslexia. I have ADHD. I have everything. I have everything.
I had to read out loud last night. Ugh,
dude. I went on yesterday and I see a tweet and I'm like, oh, this is gonna be funny. I retweeted it, and it was the joke was already done in the thing, and I retweeted it and just somewhere back.
I saw that.
Someone goes, "Hey, boomer, that was the joke, stupid." And I was like, "Okay." And I wrote back, "Hey, don't get snarky with me, yeah, young man, because I was in jail. Yeah. I was in 13, 10, I was drinking. I was doing blow and getting laid at 11, 12. I was in juvie jail at 13. I was fucking a criminal when I was supposed to be learning these skills.
Yes.
I didn't have them. And now I get too excited. Words get backwards and I type shit. Then my response, the spelling was off. And somewhere, I love when he tries to spell. It's
Jesus so, Christ.
I'm illiterate.
But you're like my mom.
I am illiterate. I admit it. This would be me and Voss. They used to call on ONA. They used to say you're stupid. Here's the problem with me. I admit I'm stupid. Voss thinks he's a genius. Yeah. That's what makes him
stupid. The legend?
That's why it makes him stupider than me. I say we're both stupid, probably evenly dumb, but you're dumber than me because you don't know it.
Yeah.
You think you're smart.
That's dangerous.
That's dangerous.
Yeah. Dangerous dumb.
Yeah. Twitter is a fucking, I shouldn't be on it.
Yeah.
I shouldn't.
You sound like my mom on the internet.
By the way, whenever you see, oh no, these pictures were leaked, do not click on that.
God damn it.
Why?
It has gotten me like 12 times in the last month.
It just is the most filthy porn. Every tweet is like an OnlyFans model.
Well, why wouldn't you click on it?
Well, because I'm trying to quit porn.
Oh.
Well, I keep getting tricked into like video leaked of P. Diddy. Like the P. Diddy thing going on right now.
But why would you click
that? I want to see that shit.
Listen,
I want to see
it.
It
doesn't even exist, I don't think.
They have, banging.
The audio. The audio's out.
Have you heard the audio?
I got it. You want
to
hear it?
I would love to hear it. I don't know. I would love to hear it.
Is Meek Mill getting it?
Do you want to hear it?
I woke up to his song. Do I got to change my song?
Do you want
to
hear it? Do you want to hear it?
I do. I'm in.
I got it right here. You ready?
I didn't know. This is...
This is it, man. I got it.
We may never be
here. This is not going to be real.
This is real, dude. Here it comes.
This might be the end.
This is it.
This is the end.
Here it is. Here it is. Ready? Wait, that's not it.
Well, it's like, sounds like fucking horses.
That's a handicapped person in a relay race. Here we go. No, it's her again. What the fuck? Oh, they must have took it down. They must have took it down. It's gone, dude.
God damn.
That sucks. Here, let's see if it comes up now.
All the champagne was spiked, son. Yeah. Like, all the champagne was spiked. Everybody was passed the fuck out. I don't drink, so I was playing that shit off. Like, I don't fucking drink. I smoke, nigga. Like, I smoke and I had my own weed, but, like, everybody was passed out. Yo, Diddy had that man in the room. Look, yes, I put my ear to the fucking door and I brought the phone because Diddy started going in overdrive. I ain't know what the fuck was going on, but I just heard balls slapping against ass cheeks. I heard niggas struggling to take dick. I heard niggas being like, yeah, Daddy. Like, when he started all that Daddy this and Daddy that, and then I heard some hollering and struggling, like, yeah, I kept the phone there. And I recorded all that shit because I was like, this nigga Diddy rich. So I'm finna put the squeeze on and get me a couple dollars and just say, you know what I'm saying? There's nobody believed that was really Diddy beating Meek back in. But now,
oh my God.
Now y'all motherfuckers believe the video, right?
Yeah, there you go.
By the way, holy from now shit. On, I will refer wild. To gay sex as hollering and struggling. That's what he is. Oh, he's one of those hollering and strugglers. Dude,
that's
huh?
wild.
There's something about it where it's uncomfortable because you hear, you know, it's like black dudes fucking each other. It just sounds like dudes fucking, you know, Like when you're a white dude, there's always one that's the girl. It's like, oh, ooh, yeah. Oh, daddy. Yeah. Like, oh, you fucking like that? Black dude's like, come on, motherfucker. Shit. It's like, one of you got to lighten up and be the girl to make this all right to listen to. Yeah. It can't be two dudes going, yeah, oh, fuck, wild. dude. Oh, dude. Fuck, you like that? No. Dude, shit, dude.
It can't be, oh, dude. Yeah, dude. Oh, dude.
That's me and Billy Burr fucking, dude. Dude, fucking dude, fucking easy, you cocksucking fucking dude.
Nobody, none of the aughts are enjoying this.
No, they're enjoying it.
They're like, that's homophobic.
No, they're not. They're all fucking, these guys are all pieces of shit. Fucking Danny was in a club last night walking around trying to get pussy. All night, look like a bird, like a dodo bird.
Danny, what is your pickup line? How do you throw game at the ladies?
I have zero game.
What's your initial, hey?
I don't know. I just go up, I ask their name and try to start a conversation.
No, he goes, can I get your Instagram?
Yeah.
No, that's not the opening line.
That's the closing line. You know, they want nothing to do with you. You want to stalk them, break them down.
I don't know. So yesterday we were at the casino, so we just asked people whether they were in town, if they were at the casino for something in particular, just to start up a conversation, and I don't know, and then see where it goes, and then it led nowhere.
Do you have a type?
He gets girls, dude. Sam, listen to me. He gets girls, and I told him, I feel like he's gotten girls where I'm like, did you develop like a ray or something where it goes over your skin, where they're seeing something
like
I'm not.
Shapeshifter?
Yeah, like he's.
Are you saying the Jews are shapeshifters, dude?
I think that person might be, because, dude, he got a girl in Florida where I was like, get the fuck. I was like, dude, I want to talk
it's
to her.
Florida, though.
Yeah, maybe you're right.
Yeah, Florida's different.
She wasn't from Florida.
I'm 53.
Okay, I'm 51.
Okay.
When we were young, if a girl had camel toe, she had to like leave town and move away.
Yeah.
Like, it was a whole different thing. Like the numbers that we could put up today.
Yeah.
With what we did in the back, it's like Wilt Chamberlain in the WNBA. We would put insane numbers up right now. You guys have no clue. When we were young, age, all the women were dressed like fucking lesbian lumberjacks, right? Grunge. Yeah.
All the waitresses were into it.
Yeah.
Now you can't touch a waitress.
Oh, it sucks.
No, you
they
can't.
They ruined it for themselves.
They did. We used to have fun.
Yeah.
Oh, you go through when you hire a new waitress, what's up?
Yeah.
Oh, it was
great. Get it ran through? Oh. Come on, dog.
I remember I had two waitresses.
I respect you and your person,
Hi. Hey, them, thee, they, she, be. Yeah, crazy. It's over, though. The game's over. It's a different game. And I'm happy. I'm happy that it went down this way. Because the man of today, I was talking about this weekend, the man of today's of our generation was, Elvis was the motherfucking king, Frank Sinatra, and now they have Elon Musk and Bezos. It's a different game. Back in the day, we used drugs in our dicks and muscles and music to get laid, right?
Yeah.
You could pull your penis out.
Yeah.
And they wouldn't, they'd be like,
That was Ari Shaffir's closer for like most of his career.
Just pulling his dick
pulling
out.
Pulling his dick
can't
out.
Can't do it
Everyone
no more.
Laughing at those long balls.
Yeah, now these guys are fucking, you have to have millions and be respectful.
Yeah.
Oh. And be a, you know what I mean? Like, how unfun is it for girls right now?
Yeah.
Right?
I think they hate it, actually. I've been with girls where, like, I got a couple kids. But where there was like, you're trying to be respectful on that shit. And I was like, hey, do you mind if we do? She's like, what are you asking, you fucking psycho? I don't know. I was scared.
Yeah, you made us ask.
Yeah, you made.
You fucking scared the shit out of us.
Hollywood female comedians ruined it for everybody.
Yeah.
They ruined it for everybody, these fucking Hollywood female comics. They made everything androgynous. Why? They're out just fucking the staff and married guys, but they're like, it's so hard to be us. You don't understand, it's sexual. Then they're doing comedy on OnlyFans. It's like, you don't know if you're coming or going, dude. Then you go on the road, nobody hits on anybody.
Yeah.
It's just
it's wild.
It is kind of unfair where it's like, respect me. I'm not sexual. Be respect. Don't come at me like that. And as soon as the pandemic hit, hey, I'm going to cook bacon and show you my asshole for $8.
Like, hey, do respect me. I'm not a sex object. But my hour of comedy is about my pussy. Anyways, right?
Well, but it also doesn't work.
But I don't care.
I don't care. Do whatever you
just
want.
Just let me talk about your pussy, too.
Yes. That's my whole thing.
Let me talk about farts, cum, blowjobs, and don't make me feel like a piece of shit.
I totally agree, dude. I just shot my special. I'm like, you know what? We're going to do some well-crafted, multi-layered dick jokes. And you're going to enjoy it, like, because that's comedy. It's not just from chicks either.
Yes.
Guys are allowed to talk about pussies, too.
Yes, but not anymore. That's no, we gotta be fucking witty and cunning.
Yeah.
And talk about shit and
that
not
was
offend
clever.
You can't offend anybody.
That's a clever comedy.
Oh,
right
fuck
there.
Clever.
I think it's swinging back. I think it feels like 2 years ago, for sure, that's where we were. But I think now, you know, I mean, I think it's the fact they even had Gillis on SNL, you can see that it's coming back. Everyone's
dude,
like, yeah,
Ryan
we're fucking tired.
Headlining comedy clubs. That's a sign that we're fucking winning. When Brian Holtzman is hosting.
He's great.
Oh, he's the best.
Yeah.
But he just doesn't care.
Yeah, he's so funny.
And it's just like people are bringing him out knowing he might walk half the crowd.
He will totally walk at least one big group.
Why is he going to walk? What is he doing?
I break comics down into three groups. Clowns.
Yeah.
Shit talkers.
Yeah.
And outlaws.
Okay.
And he's an outlaw. He just doesn't care.
Yeah, outlaw. I want to be an outlaw, but I feel like I'm a shit-talking clown.
You're a shit-talking clown.
Yeah. I am. I want to be an outlaw.
Clowns.
What do I got to do to be an outlaw?
Shit-talkers become legends.
Can I play clubs.
Yeah, but you're such a killer, dude.
But can I do something to become an outlaw? What do I have to do?
Pull your dick out.
Do I got to get warts?
Drop a
should I get warts
bombs
and show people? And bonds.
Oh, well, listen, don't go
talk about
on
you're, talking about, you're talking about an outlaw back in the 1800s. you live in
Houston.
You live in Houston. And you're not married now.
Not married.
You're single. You got two
single,
kids.
Single, two kids. One Mexican, one white.
Yeah.
Pretty exciting stuff.
He told a great story on those two gay guys podcast. What's the name again?
Joe List and Mark Norman.
Yeah. That
two sets of stories.
Yeah, no, they're great. They're gay. He told the story in front of a room full of people. This is what I love about comics. And I was trying to explain this to Danny today. You can sit there and write as much as you want. You can be as good as writing a setup and a punch and a tag and have as much new material as you fucking want. But there's funny people, and then there's people who do this as a job, who learn how to do it, and they do it, and they can swing their act, and they're funny. I would never take away.
I agree.
And, you know, I love writers. Gary Gulman, one of my favorite and one
he's
of the best at it.
I love him.
But he's funny. He's funny with, if you did, he was funny back in the day, and he used comedy to get out his shit.
Yes.
He went on stage and revealed, that guy went on, quit comedy, became a teacher, did shock therapy and then wrote an hour about it and said, fuck you.
He's a great
and it was like, wow, that to me. And he told a joke he told a story. I don't know if it's in your act.
It's actually not. It's just a fucking crazy
story. Buddy,
why don't you put in your act?
It's crazy.
It's pretty wild.
He told the crowd at the Gramercy. He told everybody. This is why I love it. He just told the story. And we all had questions. We kept stopping. He wanted to just tell the story, but we were like, whoa, 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 whoa.
That's a lot.
One guy took you, and then he put it in another guy's mouth. What? And he's like,
what? By the way, I just want to say the future of comedy to me is authenticity.
Yes.
The more real, it's like the exact opposite of what it was in the 80s.
Yes.
It was like the more authentic you can be, the more honest you are about how retarded you are, more people love that because they're looking for a lighthouse in a sea of shit. So Lil B told me that's the story you should be telling on stage.
The fact that he told that in front of Norton, Mark, me, and Joe, three killers, who are going to...
That's four people. So one of them's not.
Yeah, one of them's not. me. And, I mean, Norton had it, but he doesn't have it anymore. No, I'm kidding. He's one of the fastest guys in the world. But the fact that you told that in front of us, but he went down there and he was in a gay bar. Can you tell
me? No, I went to Mexico. I was
so fun.
I went. I lived with this girl And she was my roommate at the time. No, no. She looked like looked like him. It was not great. But that was my roommate.
I'd be a good looking girl.
No, you know, you'd be hotter than her. So we go to Mexico. I'm just a broke 25-year-old. You know, she's like, I got you. Right. And she's like, I'll pay for everything. Let's just go. And I was like, that seems a little weird. But hey, I'm broke. Why not? I mean, I've never been to Mexico. I go to Mexico. We're walking down the street. It's Matamoros, Mexico. There's like a main street. And then there's this guy out front of this bar, and in Spanish, he goes, $13 all you can drink. And we're like, hell yeah, that sounds fucking awesome. So we go up, we get in, and they have a buffet-style bar. Like, it's serve yourself, like, horchata containers of liquor. Like, it's fucking weird. And we get hammered, and we're partying, we're having a good night. This girl walks up to me. She's like, hey, you want to talk to my friend? And I was like, yeah, I'd love to meet a Mexican woman while I'm here. And then we're, like, dancing a little bit more. All of a sudden, I'm surrounded by, like, 8 to 10 guys, and I was like, oh shit, we're in a gay bar. And I'm like hammered at this point. I'm like, I don't know how to get out of here. Plus there's a language barrier. I don't know how to say, like, I don't want
there's also an exit.
Yeah, well, you know, I'm panicking.
This is what he does.
This is what I do. I go, I gotta go to the bathroom. I was like, I'll figure that
which
out.
Which is right? Code for I'm gonna suck everybody's dick. I mean, literally, it's literally,
yeah, it's, yeah.
When you're in a gay bar, when you wanna suck dick, you go, I gotta pee. Yeah. And then everybody goes with you.
Oh, yeah. And so I walk to the bathroom. I go in the stall. I'm like just sitting there pretending to pee with my cock out. And then two guys follow me into the stall.
That's another code, too. Yeah. Saying I have to pee and not peeing.
Well, yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah. I'm really setting myself up for failure.
I don't hear anything, senor.
Yeah, yeah. Well, no, so I no turn pickle, around. Pickle. And one of them grabs my dick and starts sucking it. I was like, oh, shit. And then the other one grabs it out of his mouth, puts it in his. And I was like, this is feeling pretty good, but I was like I support you guys. I don't really support this happening, so I gotta get the fuck out of here. And security comes in, like bangs on the door, and I was like, I wasn't doing anything. I didn't do anything. And I get up and I leave, and I grab my friend. I was like, we gotta get the fuck out of here.
Did you get hard at all?
Oh yeah,
so good. No, you got
it was
hard.
Fucking good. What are you talking about?
So he comes in, you're like, I'm not doing anything while you're
yeah,
rock
yeah,
on.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I mean, it was fucking. Whatever, you know, it is. It felt good.
Your dick smells like tequila and tacos.
It's
so funny that you supported.
Yeah.
How long did you go before you told them to stop? How many gulps did they get in?
First of all, dude, you don't have to be politically correct in Mexico. It's not like it was San Francisco where they're going to have a parade at your hotel the next day.
Yeah.
He took our dicks, his dick out of our mouth and said mean shit. They don't give a shit.
No.
I mean, they both had wives.
I'll say
they did enough. No, they were like, so they could pass like it.
Hot
like
little
ball.
Gay twinks. They were in makeup on, whatever. They were like
my favorite
enough.
Part that he fucking one guy was sucking his dick. He had enough time to grab it.
It was quick.
Put it in another guy's mouth.
Mexicans are fast, dude.
We'll reenact it right now, and we'll time it. That's not quick.
Yeah.
If you're gonna go in, take your dick out. One guy has. First of all, getting hard, right? Were you hard when you were peeing?
No.
So that getting hard takes a couple.
That took at least trace gulps.
Yeah, I'm saying we're probably going
gulps.
I'd say 10 to 20 seconds. I think we're sitting 10 to 20 seconds in the whole
thing.
So
you're drunk, so your reaction time's even slower.
Oh, it's bad. Right, okay.
They were probably slobbing in for about 5 minutes before.
Not about five.
It was probably around 20 minutes. Yeah. It was probably more than two guys. Yeah. It was probably like 13 dudes.
Everyone's just hitting.
I mean, they have a photo of him on the wall with a dick in his hand. He's the champion.
Like it's a food challenge.
Yeah, you won a championship.
He's like,
the greatest gringo in Mexico.
Oh, so funny, dude.
Oh, shit. It's such a me happy.
Yeah.
When we were at a show last night and I was talking to the crowd and I'm sitting there and I was trying to talk about like, because you ever do some gay stuff, like, you know, little gay stuff. We've all done little gay. And I hate that guys are never for. I'm glad that guy's dying.
Yeah, right.
Where it's like, maybe. And I was like talking to this couple. I'm like, do you ever did anything crazy? He's like, nah. He's looking at his wife, older couple. Nah. I'm like, you never did anything wild, nothing, role play, anything? He's like, no. I'm like, fuck, I don't believe you. He goes, I don't know, I pissed on her face once. I was like, what? The fucking placement. I walked off stage. I was like, how do you fucking get there? And it was so
I got
funny.
A great peeing story.
Oh, you do? You peed on somebody?
So
who hasn't?
One time, yeah.
You have never once.
I said one girl wanted me to pee on her. On the phone with her, she's like, "I want you to pee on me." And I was okay, I don't. My father, my real dad, who I never talked to in my life, really, we had spurts. At this point, we were talking for a couple months. He clicked in. I said, "Hang on." I clicked over. My real dad, really, no relationship, really. I said, "Hey, Dad, this girl wants me to pee on her. What do I do?" He goes, "Well, I wouldn't muster up a piss and drink a gallon of water, but you got to piss. Go ahead." Some of the greatest dad advice ever.
Yeah, yeah.
If he was only in my life for that long, I was great. And that's the way I played it.
What is the best lesson your father ever taught you?
I wouldn't muster up a piss.
Yeah.
I wouldn't drink a gallon of water and muster up a pee, but if you got a pee, go ahead. What a great advice. So, what are you saying?
So, we were at the Comedy Store one day, and this woman walks by, and she looks exactly like Miley Cyrus. We're like, holy shit, you look like Miley Cyrus. So, somehow, we're at the store. This is during the chaos, when it was the dark period, somehow got to, "Would you pee on me?" I don't know how we got to this, but she's like, "Yeah, I would pee on you." And I go, "You'll never do it." She goes, "I'll totally do it." Next thing you know, we're in the back main room where the dancers used to dance when it was Ciro's.
Yeah.
There's a shower. I'm laying down. The room is full. People are betting on whether she's going to pee on. It's like some shit I do a joke about, but it was like some shit like Deer Hunter. Like, so she's like laying. She's like, "I can't pee. I can't." I go, I knew you wouldn't do it. She's like, "I really want to pee on you." I'm like, "Well, do you want, let's go to my house and you can pee on me." She's like, "Okay." She'll come on me. So we go to my house.
What? Did all the people
come? I lay
come?
Down and she just totally pees on me. I'm like, "This isn't that bad." So I get up. She starts putting her clothes on. I go, "What are you doing?" She goes, "What?" I go, "Why are you putting your clothes back on?" She's like, "Oh, we're going to have sex." I go, "I'm not a porta potty." This is the whole thing. And then later on, about 6 months later, there's the AMA Awards, right? The American Music Awards. And we see Miley Cyrus dancing. She runs down the fucking way. They're sitting the real Miley Cyrus. It was that chick. Was Miley Cyrus's double in that act. She's the one that peed on me. When you can actually YouTube it.
No way.
Yeah, she's the one who peed on me.
I want to know one thing. Did the people get their money back for betting when you left?
Well, they lost. Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Oh, that was just
they bet and then she could do it. They
yeah,
lost,
stage fright
bro.
Or anything.
That
didn't matter.
That stinks.
Insane. Yeah.
That's. I love that the store, though, dude, what was that, 90s?
Chaos. No, it was like early 2000s.
I mean, dude, what
it was blow and that's all. You did stand-up was secondary.
Yeah.
And there was no industry there, so you could like bomb in with dignity. Dude.
Yeah.
The purest comedy ever was.
Does industry still go to the clubs in L.A.?
Yeah. I mean, like, they're trying to hold on to it, but
every nobody time cares. I go to the store to hang out, I always see like five agents that are like, "Oh, hey,
yeah. They're so, all over there, dude. Yeah.
They're all hammered." And
so, listen, I want to get into this really now. We got Sam's got the Tinfoil Hat Podcast, Conspiracy Social Club, and I just found out the dojo. I was trying to work it out for a long time to go out there and do it, I just never could. But then Danny, who has a show, he was like, "Dude, we'll work it out. We'll make it right. You know, we'll whatever we need to do to get us." And then I did it, and I was like, "It's the best."
Thank you, dude.
It's the best because they treat you right. I know a club is legit when other comics are there. When the younger generation are hanging out, that's when you got something. When a community is started because it's like, "Oh, this is the place."
Yeah,
they're like young comics always. Go to someplace like the Cellar, the Boston Comedy Club, or the Stand, and then it was New York Comedy Club. They're the ones there first, and then the other guys come.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying?
Yes.
So
community. You got to have a hangout.
It's got to be a hang, and I thought it was, I had such a blast over there.
Thank you.
Because there's other clubs in Jersey, I'm just like, whatever.
Yeah.
Because it's about the moolah. It's about, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And fuck you. So when you go and you hang out, and you feel good, and they make you feel like important, and they care about the comedy and the crowds. I had such a blast. I had such a good time at
this. This is a true story. So one day I get a call from this chick. She's like, "Hi, I represent this comedy club in Jersey, and they really want you to play there."
Yeah.
And I go, "What's the name of the comedy club?" She goes, "The Chuckle Shack." I go, tell him I'll play it, but I'm not playing a Chuckle Shack. And she goes, well, I go, I'm not playing a Chuckle Shack. That's the worst name I've ever heard in my fucking life.
Yeah.
So he calls me up, Mike, and he's like, what's going on? I go, dude, I'll play your club. I'm not playing a Chuckle Shack. That's the hackiest shit I've ever heard. He goes, I don't know what she named it. I go, call it Tiff's Comedy or whatever you called it before that. Let's do it. So I come out and I play the room, and it's an all white room, dude.
Right, which is the way your crowd.
Yeah, yeah.
Right?
It was an Aryan clan rally. No, yeah, yeah. The room
Anthony
was Kumi all white.
Was up front.
White. It was like doing stand-up in like a surgery.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Right? Right? So it was like, I'm like, bro, we got to darken this room. So we made a deal because I had a comedy club, like an underground comedy club in LA called the Dojo of Comedy. So I talked to him, like, let's call it the Dojo of Comedy.
Great name.
Let's get it going. It's called the Dojo of Comedy.
Mm-hmm.
And so we're just going, I go, dude, you got to paint the room black. So the pandemic hits. He's doing everything to keep it going. He really crushed it. He had outdoor shows, all this shit. So then it's kind of, we have a down pair. I'm like, paint it black. So he painted it black. He's like, dude, you're totally right. We turned into a mini original room of the Comedy Store. We just put down a nice fucking stage.
Yeah,
it's gorgeous, dude.
Great room, man.
Thank you, dude.
And
Mike's great. Mike's too. Romanelli's.
Yeah, but he's great too, because I went in there one time and to do a spot, I think, and he was just the nicest guy in the world. And that means a lot, dude. When you show up, hey, man, whatever you need, blah, blah, that little thing of just, man, we're glad you're here makes you feel good.
Yeah.
When you show up and there's no parking for you,
yeah,
there's they're kind of fucking with you, and they're not, they treat you like you're one of the wait staff.
Yes.
I'm out. I'm just out. I don't need it.
I can't do these corporate clubs, dude. Doing stand-up at a Dave and Buster's.
Yeah.
And it's just...
Some of them I like.
Corporate.
Some of them I like. It's fine. But the Dojo is great. And you got a new special. What's your special called again?
I'll tell you this. Mark Norman's YouTube. It's so weird promoting someone else's
No,
YouTube.
It's great. Dude,
let me tell you something.
Fuck
so strange.
No, it isn't, right, man.
Yeah, yeah.
Dude.
No, I get it. I understand. It's awesome. It's cool. I mean, Mark has been a great supporter.
Buddy, that's awesome. What he should be doing.
Of course. It's awesome.
Like Shane Gillis did
but
that
But it is
about.
A funny thing.
Shane did it. Louis did it for me.
Yeah.
It's, I mean, great, my comic's like way better than your comic, but it's way better than...
Totally.
I mean, 100%. But, I mean, he's awesome. But no, dude, that's what they should be doing.
Yeah.
I love that comics are picking other dudes up and helping them out and give, dude, I'm telling you right now, there's some people that didn't do that and it sucks. And the fact that he's doing that, that's great. I love it. What's the name of it again?
I'll tell you this.
Tell me.
March
28th.
Yeah, yeah.
What is it?
March 28th.
What's
I'll tell
the name
you this.
Of it?
That's the one.
Tell me the fucking name.
Son of a bitch.
What's going on? What's the name of it?
Well, now I got to change the name. I'll tell you this. March 28th.
That's great.
I think 8 p.m. it's going to release live. We'll be there.
Okay. I got a game to play. Listen, let's I told you before, I love your...
Thank you.
Because you have conspiracies and you've always been this guy and you're passionate about it.
Yeah.
But you're out looking. I'm not smart enough and I don't have enough time.
I flunked first grade, just so you know.
Fine. I did too. I flunked too. So I held back, right? You held back.
You
right?
flunked first grade twice.
I was held back in first grade.
Yeah,
just
and then
one.
You got held
one
back
time.
Again.
No, one time.
Okay, respect.
But then I quit school at like 13. I walked in seventh grade. I was out for 2 weeks. I just was out drinking and drugging. I came back. My teacher went, "Nice that you can make it to school." I went, "Go fuck yourself." And then I left. And then I never went back to school.
Damn, bro, you
until
were
until ninth
were...
grade. Well, no, eighth grade. I went back, and then I got put in the rubber rooms in the basement with snakes and weight benches. And then I beat up the gym teacher, me and this other
snaps.
Kid. And we got suspended for the last 3 weeks or 2 weeks of school. And they just gave me a stack of papers. Do these papers, you pass. This Jewish girl I was fucking, smoking hot.
Jew broads are the best.
The best. She did my work and then fucked me.
That's
and it was
the
great.
Best.
So I passed
that's
because awesome. Of her. So I through all that stuff I missed. But I just don't have the ability to like investigate a conspiracy theory, because you could say one thing and I'll be like, yeah, dude, fuck that. Biden, man, I'm voting for Biden. You can be like, dude, this is what he did. And be like, fucking Biden's a piece of shit. Trump, I'm voting for Trump. I'm not kidding. I'm not kidding, dude.
Yeah.
I flip flop easy.
Yeah.
I flip flop easy. I'm not going to tell you who
you
I voted
flip-flop
for.
Flip flop?
Flip flop. My word. I invented flip flop.
I like that.
It's my thing.
Flip-flop. I love that you think Youngblood is a Biden voter, by the way. That's
I'm just, no, I just said he looks like.
I mean, like, I don't know, maybe.
No comment.
No comment.
Yeah, I'll throw it out there. I hate all of them. Yeah, I hate all of them. Yeah. I fucking think it's all stupid. But when it comes down to it, I'll probably have to vote for Biden because there's nothing. I don't want to vote for the other guy.
Yeah, freedom. Who cares about that?
I don't know. I hate them. I hate them all. I hate them all.
Okay, how really about not do. Voting then?
You know,
do you like where things are? I mean, they.
I feel like if I don't vote, I get yelled at.
New York City. Listen, New York City literally has like aspects of martial law going right now. When they have the National Guard in the subway, that's martial law. When you have the AG trying to find out who booed her, which firefighters booed her, so they can go into literally what she called re-education camps, that's straight up martial. That's always been it. They want to break us down so badly. We're in a Bolshevik war right now, dude, but nobody wants to talk about. So, like, the fact that you don't like Trump, I'm totally fine, because I could sit here and listen to you all the things that Trump did that was fucked up.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
I could get it. But to be like, I'm going to vote for Biden because I don't want to vote for Trump, is like, that's not the lesser two evils. That's just like, that's just why you'll never see New York City change. You'll never see San Francisco change, because there's just a group of people that the theory of voting for someone on the right is worse than what's actually happening on the streets.
I would vote for someone on the right.
America! Fuck yeah!
I would totally vote for someone on the right.
And you didn't.
I don't know. I'm also a fucking idiot. Like, I'm so dumb that, like...
Listen, that's my thing, so don't take that. That's my thing.
I'm illiterate, dude.
Yeah.
Yeah, no.
Functionally illiterate.
Here's the thing. I'm stupid, too, and I'm a registered Democrat my whole life. But things are a little fucking crazy when you bring something up that Biden did, they just assume that I voted for Trump and I'm a Trump guy, and they just bring up Trump stuff. And it's like, can we just talk about this guy's doing without bringing up the other people?
Yeah.
Can we just... Don't it's like when I fight with my wife. Yeah. It's like, you did this. Yeah. It's like, yeah, but what about what you did?
Yes.
Yes, I did do that. And I'm sorry. Now, what about you?
Yeah.
Now, what about you? Yeah. Well, you did this too. It's like, just a mirror. And that's the one thing I hate about the Democrats is they will not deal with the stuff that's in front of them that the guy that is the president is doing that is bad.
Yeah.
You would rather let this country fall apart and divide and hate your neighbors and be than to say, you know what? Fuck him too. He's bad.
Yeah.
And because that would hold them accountable. So even if they won, they'd be accountable if their people were like, no, we're not doing that anymore. But they don't. It's always the other guy's fault. And it used to be that a little bit, but now it's almost religious-like. I feel like they took God, you know, out. We all used to believe in something. You know what I mean? Kids were brought up in a church, whatever it was, Muslim, Catholic, Christian. What?
Sorry.
For what? What was it?
My dad sent me a thing.
Is he dead? Is your dad dead?
That's good.
It's not good.
It's fine.
I was in the middle of I was monologuing.
This is an epic rant.
I was monologuing, you fucking liberal. I just think that's the problem with it. And then they go, and if you see, I feel like somehow Republicans became Democrats, because it used to be like Republicans were flipping out about Jesus and God and fuck that and get these records off the shelf and it's devil, devil, devil. And now it's the other guys can't have a conversation without snapping and then going, yeah, you're an ugly, fucking ugly asshole.
Yep.
And it's like, what? Like, you have no composure anymore.
Yeah.
Which I just can't abide by that.
I agree.
I can't do it. You know what I mean? And I'm not going to vote.
Censorship now, when we were coming up, the censorship was from the right to the left. Now it's the left to the right.
At the UK.
They can't admit it. Yeah.
The UK. If you say certain things.
Yeah.
The UK.
Yeah.
The king and the queen and the... Well, we got a lot of our shit from.
Yeah.
You can't say certain words. You can't do certain things.
These guys in Trigonomics, I don't know if you've ever seen that podcast, but they're one of the guys is getting interviewed, and he goes, how many people do you think in Russia got arrested for something they posted on social media? And the guy goes, I don't know. And he goes, the number is 400 people. He goes, how many, and this is in the UK, he goes, how many people in Britain do you think got arrested last year for posting things, for posting something on social media? He goes, I don't know. He goes, 3,300.
Wow.
3,300 people. Wow. And one of it was lyrics to a rap song that her, this woman's friend had died. It was his favorite rap song. So she just posted the lyrics and she got arrested and thrown in jail for that shit.
Insane.
Insane. But it's social media is so bad because it exposes your life, your private thoughts. Some now we have to put it out there. Like she has to put her favorite song out there to everybody who might hate her.
Yeah.
And then they can expose her and get them fucked up. The cop, it's crazy. Yeah. And if it keeps going, it's coming here.
100%.
I mean, they already kind of do. I mean,
we have social credit.
Like, I'm a liberal, but I fucking hate.
Are you a liberal?
I'm a Texas liberal, so that's very liberal,
not a progressive. You know, it's much different.
No. Like I said, I'm retarded, so I don't know the terms.
Not retarded enough to get blown by two guys in a bathroom.
Hey, that's pretty liberal.
You're smart about that. What's up, son?
Guys, hurry up! I'm not into this.
Hey, give it to him for a minute. Stop being selfish.
He gave it.
You're just fucking dick whipping him. I'm not into this.
One, two, three. Here,
I'm telling you, if I was in my 30s at the time, I'd probably let him finish. I'm just saying.
It actually, when you hit your 50s, you let him finish too.
Yeah, 100%.
You're just happy you can
get
up at that
point. A good dick sucking is a good dick
sucking.
And you guys keep a secret. Si, senor.
Listen, the conspiracy thing, we're going to play a little game.
Okay.
And, this is guess what conspiracy theories are real or fake. Okay. All three of us are going to play.
Okay. Oh, I'm in.
And this is where you're going to, are we going to have to put the headphones on?
Not yet. When we, there's gonna be some video parts that maybe you will need, but not yet.
All right, thank you, Danny. How's your dad?
Yeah, I don't know. He called 3 times and then he left a voice.
Is he still mad at you about talking about that pretty dick in the text?
Yeah, he's very upset about that.
What happened? I don't know. He's texting his dad about pretty dick. Which there are pretty dicks, let's face it.
Yeah, but not Danny's.
Yeah, there's no way you look like that and just have the most proportional pretty dick. Right?
I bet his dick looks exactly like his weird thumb. All right, what do you got, Danny?
Okay, so I'm going to name one, and then we're going to have, let's go have Bobby and Andrew guess first, and then Sam guess last on if this is a real conspiracy, meaning it's out there or we made it up.
Okay.
Nancy Pelosi has surveillance listening devices hidden within her breast implants.
I mean, she's got great knockers.
Dude, she's like 90 with 40-year-old tits.
Yeah. Man, I want to see him.
Yeah.
It is.
I wish that
like
guy.
Like a Marco Island swinger, for sure.
I wish that guy who beat up her husband went in and took those out.
Yeah.
That was on a video camera.
Such great tits on
just
a lizard.
Cranked him with a hammer and then went in and just scooped one out. And just, man, she's got good boobs.
Great tits.
Yeah.
But, dude, she's been around since JFK, bro. You see her in Washington with JFK.
That's
they've been
nuts.
Running trains on that chick forever, dude.
What were her tits like back then? When did she?
I'm sure they were great then. Oh,
she got a boob job at some point.
No.
No, you don't know. Dude. You think look at those. I mean, look at those, bro. Dude.
God
I love
damn.
The sauce, those.
I mean, dude.
Even pixelated, it looks great.
Who'd you rather have, young gay Mexicans working your shaft or 80-year-old fat tit Nancy Pelosi?
I mean,
Pelosi?
Listen, dude. The fact that she's wearing that means she's a dirty bird.
Yeah, yeah.
You don't care. You're not, I mean, she has to be a liberal.
Yeah, 100%.
God, those are fantastic. I would love to see
it.
I would say, what do you say? You go first.
I say it's out there. I don't think it's real. I think that that's, but I do think it's a conspiracy theory that's definitely out there.
Okay.
For sure someone's saying that on the internet.
I'm saying her nipples are made of the AirPod Pro 2.
Bluetooth.
That fucking owner and her got together and she listens. Yes, I say it's true.
Like, I would like to believe that her nipples are so big it's like a fucking... Like a
dish?
A fucking, yeah, a dish.
Yeah, like it.
Right?
Yeah. Some the aliens weird, talk to
Antenna, right?
Yeah.
I'm going to go No, that's not true, because I just don't know if they got that technology to put in your body. Oh. But I also believe that we're so far beyond like chips and all that stuff that like people don't realize what's really going out there, which is they've hardwired sorcery and it's all frequency. But so I'm going to go no.
Sam, the question isn't, is it real? The question is, did we make it up or is it out there?
I think you made it up.
I say it's real.
Okay, Sam's right. Real. We made it up.
The Tizzy 3 made that up?
Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah.
What?
The beat up boys good. Made it.
That's pretty good. So I was wrong.
Yes.
Yeah, me too.
Sam was right.
So I was wrong.
Yes.
Okay.
Number two. The rapper Gucci Mane is a clone. After he was released from prison in 2016, people think he seems like a different person. So they think the rapper Gucci Mane that went into prison is different than the one that came out because he acts differently post-prison.
Yeah, the guy that went who was a hard rapper, he came out a sissy. His name's Prada now.
North Face.
All right. I think he. How long did you go to jail for? Do we know?
Oh, wow, you're getting into this.
Oh, I'm trying to.
This guy's
think
working
about this a little bit, right?
Yeah, no. This is the nerd.
I think he went in there and he went to jail and he probably got fucked with a bunch because he's a famous guy in jail. Mm. And then maybe he just came out differently. I went to jail for 2 weeks and I felt like it changed me. So, yeah. Like, you know, it's a shitty place. So,
You got that fraction on your arm right there? That fraction tattoo?
Yeah, basically. No, well, yeah, that's
how many guys do you have to suck off?
Yeah, 1 out of 10 guys.
1 out of 10? Yeah, that's not bad. That's not bad.
1 out of 10?
Hey, they kept me safe. So, it was a hard 2 weeks.
You couldn't wait 2 weeks?
No, it was fine.
The first day, I'll suck everybody's dick. Yeah. Yo, homes, you're getting out in 2 weeks, man. Chill.
I gotta survive.
Yo, I need cigarettes, dude.
Don't give me their pockets.
Andrew was like a 1940s phone operator in prison. Hello,
this
hello,
pockets
hello,
just
hello,
turned
hello.
Into.
Hello.
During a crisis. All right. I say. What do you say? It's true.
I say he's not a clone.
Say the story's true or not?
Okay. Out there. I don't understand.
The story out there
is
the story.
Okay. That's a story that it is out there. Sorry. Yeah. That's a real I was just story. Arguing with the actual.
I'm going to say that is a Tizzy 3.
Okay. I'm going to say that it's a story that's out there because he came out and his tattoos were in different places.
Okay, so you're right. It's we didn't make it up. That's a real thing. Sam, were you aware of that already before this?
Yes.
Okay, got it. Yes. That's a real story that's out there. Yeah.
Fuck, you know these stories.
I would bet that they can't say one that he doesn't know.
Dude,
like that anything that they say, you're gonna know.
It's a great time to clone these motherfuckers.
Wait a minute. Can I ask something? His tattoos were in a different place.
Yes.
So he went in, there's video of that.
Yeah. He went in with tattoos in one place and then came out and his tattoos were in a different place.
That's weird.
That is weird. They've been cloning shit hundreds of years ago.
Why? What are you talking about?
Why are we
about?
Cloning you didn't, Gucci Man?
Dude, stop. You just said hundreds of years ago. We didn't have cars.
No, but they were, dude, that's what
we didn't have told. Lights.
That's what you're told. That's a lie.
Who's talking to me?
Yeah. You were told that. That's a total lie.
What? Wait a minute, dude.
They had cars?
Listen to me.
Your timeline in history is a complete lie.
Wait, Sam, I love you so much.
Thank you, buddy.
I love you so much.
I love you.
What the fuck? What are you saying to
history
me?
History is a lie.
Listen to me.
Timelines are different. Tartaria, there's a famous thing called Tartaria, which is that there was an empire that has been wiped out of our history books and we're not taught about. And it's like beyond a whole, like there was a great flood that's in all these different religious and philosophical beliefs that wiped out everything. But yeah, dude, it's like.
We had electricity.
We had everything, dude.
But what do
we
you mean everything?
Free energy.
What?
Like, dude.
What?
Like, have you noticed that all these bells are all cracked? It's because vibrations and frequency can cure people. So they crack all the bells so they can't do it.
What bells?
The bells.
The Philadelphia bells?
Find a giant bell. It's cracked.
Why?
Because they don't want you understanding that frequency can cure you. Vibrations can kill you. If you get one, dude, if you have like a knot or something, get a tuning fork. Boom. Put it on it. It starts to heal it.
This is so much to unpack.
Okay, dude. Listen to me, dude. We just spent an hour
talking about hijinks. Futuristic black chicks and gay Mexicans.
And pussy.
Yeah.
And now you're talking to me.
I'm telling you.
We've had electricity.
Look up Tataria, bro.
You're going to have to
Have you ever gone
stuff.
To these small cities do comedy and every like all the architecture is just like weird? And then there's just one building that is just beautiful brick. And it just, where'd that come from? That's what they believe is Tataria.
What are you talking? What building?
Like, so you want to hear something really crazy?
It would be nice to get specific.
Really yeah, I want
to
hear. I mean, I'm hearing stuff crazy right now.
Crazier than this? Crazy shit. You want to hear
crazier
more crazy?
Than electricity?
Go home and study the ancient world fairs, like the Chicago World Fair of like 1870. Right?
Okay.
So what they'll tell you, dude, is that they built this gorgeous fair in 2 years. It's the most beautiful shit you've ever seen. It's like literally like Rome. It's beautiful. They said they built it in 2 years.
Yeah.
And then when the fair was done, they destroyed all of it.
Yeah.
And if you study, you talk to people who understand architecture, it would take 15 years just to develop, let alone build it. Dude, wiped out all this history. They're wiping out our history. They don't want you to know how special you, Robert Kelly, and
are you,
you, Andrew Young, are.
Are you a member of Wakanda?
What? Wakanda. But maybe, like,
can you tell some of my black friends
the story
they still
of slavery
do this?
Is total bullshit.
What?
Meaning no, that they did.
No, well, like 5 seconds.
You almost said the N-word earlier.
With 5 seconds out of February, dude.
Most of the African Americans.
Yep.
Blacks. Came.
Don't say it like that. Can you say it with a different tone?
Futuristic I do like how black. You quoted African American and then just go black.
Yeah. So yeah. Right, like, okay. Most of them were already here.
Here where?
Florida.
What? 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 The?
It's the Moors, bro. Yeah. I'm part Moor.
Oh, yeah.
Like
the
Sicilians
Moors invaded
Sicilians
system.
Are part Moor because they came, they conquered southern Italy.
This
and
guy.
Dropped dick on everybody. And that's why I'm
this
part,
guy.
Right? But they were already here. They were already here, Rob. They were already here.
You're an eggplant.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, I'm eggplant.
Dude,
Rob.
Listen to me. Listen to me.
Dude, your timeline's all fucked up.
All right, but
they,
wait a minute.
Africans were already here. They were Moors.
Okay,
they
so
got conquered.
There's no here. Slavery.
No, there was slavery.
Okay.
But the slaves didn't all come on slave ships. That's all bullshit.
Okay. What? So we had cars?
Well, yeah. There, you can see videos of cars way back in the day, way before.
Like
Ford
what?
Invented
when,
them.
Way back in the day. How?
Like 1800s and shit.
Where was there a car?
There was pictures of cars in San Francisco, China, all over the place.
With like horses pulling them. Though,
no, but
right?
Like, no, literally cars.
What do you mean cars?
Like cars on wheels. Like, dude, free energy. There was free energy.
What's free energy?
Free energy is ether, dude. It's one of the elements. And like they found ways to harness free energy. So we didn't have to pay for electricity and gas.
Why don't we do that now?
Because these people want they if they gave out free energy, they couldn't make money off it.
Okay, so Elon Musk.
Yes.
Why wouldn't he reveal this? And make it possible.
Because you think Elon Musk is like this. Listen, dude, most of your billionaires, your tech billionaires right now are just rich kids that were given all this stuff by their somebody in the older generation. Like a lot of people don't know this about Jeff Bezos. Everyone's like, Jeff Bezos is the hardest working guy out there. It's like, you don't know that his grandfather owned Mobil Oil and created a department of the U.S. government called DARPA where all of the futuristic technology comes from.
Mm. I didn't know that.
Yeah. So he was just, he was just picked. Right. They got data like, okay, he's a hardworking psychopath. We'll give him the technology. And they worked the technology through books because no one gives a shit. Once they fine tune it, now it's taking over everything. So when they shut down the pandemic, what was allowed to stay open? America, Amazon Fresh, you know, Walmart. And it's just like all these corporations were allowed to stay open while mom and pop stores were shut down. Like in California right now, they have this ridiculous law where they want minimum wage to be $20 an hour, except if you sell bread, right? This is a little law that they're trying to pass. If you sell bread, you don't have to give $20 an hour. So who's that help? McDonald's, any fast food restaurant, which means all the mom and pop restaurants are fucked. or anybody who owns a mom and pop store that doesn't sell bread. You're fucked. You're just fucked, dude. So,
and Nancy Pelosi's tits aren't mic'd up?
No. No.
Are you sure?
But
they had cars 200 years ago.
Yeah, yeah. Your phone's listening to you right now.
Well, we all know
I
that.
I know that.
But dude,
is Nancy Pelosi listening?
Your television's listening to you. Everything's right. listening to you.
Yeah, I don't care.
I don't care either.
No, I don't care.
I
just call up chicks, ask them to call me the M word because it's the only way I can get hard. I wish I was lying.
Anyways, all right, let's go to the next one. Yeah. Wow,
that
dude,
was a lot.
You just jammed a red pill down my throat.
I felt like I took an edible during that whole time.
Now you're going to send me
down. Look at Tartaria and the World Fairs in Chicago and just read that shit.
Yeah.
If you really want to hear some crazy stuff, go to this YouTube channel called On My Lunch Break. Oh, dude, it'll blow
I'm just going to watch. Is there like a, I'm just going to watch a Young Sheldon episode.
Yeah. There you go.
And maybe The Good Doctor.
He's not that young anymore.
He's no, like, he's not, but I'm going to watch.
He's basically Doogie Howser.
I know. That's right, yeah. But the
is there like an intro
hot.
To conspiracy? You know,
yeah, we
like,
just this, had it.
That was too much. My brain's exploding. There's too many.
It's a podcast called Tinfoil Hat.
All right, let's go. Let's go. What else?
Oh, there it is, dude. There it is.
What? Well, there's what?
Right, that?
What is that?
That is the Chicago World Fair, and they told. And there's a whole bunch of other pictures. They told everybody they built that in 2 years. All that shit.
It's gone.
And then they knocked it down. All that beauty knocked it down.
Didn't they do that for here too for the World Fair in Queens?
Yeah, dude.
They just left those remnants, but it was spaceships, right?
But it was a while. I don't know when that.
And I saw a show that those spaceships are real spaceships. And there was a bug tried to get up to it.
In black.
And thank God there's a secret society of people who protected us.
Well, all the UFOs you see is just U.S. military technology.
I believe that too. There's no way they're flying out these things by planes.
There's no such thing as aliens. They're just angels and demons.
All right, what? you have me, and then you're like Cat Williams. You have me, and then you lose me. Yeah. What the fuck?
Half of this podcast
Yo
is
man,
both of us
this
been going,
is
what?
Comics. All right, let me.
The reason aliens don't exist.
They're angels and demons.
I'm sorry.
Interdimensionals.
What?
They're not from other planets.
What's the difference? What is an angel and a demon? Like from the Bible we're talking? Yeah. You think it's 100%. Real? You believe in the...
100%.
Okay. Well, now, I don't know how to.
He even said it, dude. You were talking about the kids don't have God anymore.
They took. Well, that is a big thing that people don't. This country was founded on God. It's in everything we did. Kids were brought up with those values.
Yep.
And the mother was home. The father went to work. You're all about being with family, neighborhoods, communities. And somewhere in the last 50 years, they've stolen, they took religion out, made it bad, made it evil.
Yep.
Where kids, you ask any kid and they don't have religion, they hate it. They hate that their parents or whatever they are, except for Muslims,
and
Jewish,
Mexicans.
Mexican, Jewish, but white kids, regular white kids, they hate it. They don't like it. And when you take that out of, if you look at every religion, it's just a positive perspective.
100%.
All it is.
It's all about love.
It's all about love. Every Bible, every religion is based on a positive perspective. And the fact that they took that away from us and they replaced it with this.
Yep.
Yeah.
They replaced it with that. Now they can control us. Mom's not home. She's got to work. Everything's more expensive. Yep. Dad has to work. Yep. And now the kids are on this. They can tell their kids what to think, what to do. And there's no God. There's no treat neighbors nice. Don't fuck your neighbor's wife. Don't hurt people. Don't kill people. None of that exists in people. They're not being brought up with values or morals.
Yes.
They're being brought up with fucking internet shit.
Yeah.
Bullshit, conspiracies and all that stuff. And I don't like it.
It's so hilarious that they want to get rid of TikTok, which is the only app that the intelligence agencies don't control the data. But they're like, oh, dude, it's like, look what it's doing to our kids. I'm like, why don't you make 18 and over phones? But you'll never do that because you want to hook these kids early.
I took everything off my kid's phone.
Yeah,
everything off it. All
dude,
that's
my
gone.
Daughter
Safari,
can't stop
everything.
Watching these fucking
he just puts
Ukrainian
it
momos.
He How doesn't because I check it. I'm not a fucking asshole. Yeah, I know he's a piece of shit and he'll put it back on.
It's just crazy.
I check it. Anyways, all right, let's go. We got another one. How you got to go soon?
No.
Okay, good.
The reason we stopped calling COVID coronavirus is because the beer company gave millions of dollars to Fauci.
You're up.
I think you made that one up. Yeah, I think it's
why, because it sounds like an open mic joke.
Yeah, I think I've heard that on fucking stage before.
Yeah, Danny's been using it. Yeah, at fucking
he's just
JoJo.
Running bits by us.
Yeah, he's running.
Yeah, these fucking losers are just running their stupid new jokes by us. I'm saying boo to that too.
Yeah,
it's one of your jokes.
I don't think that's real because I don't. I think you made that up because. It would cost billions and billions of dollars for them to get that. If you really, whether it's out there, I can't tell, but I'm going to go with it's not out there. Could be, but it's not out there.
You're right. We made it up.
Okay.
Exactly.
Okay.
When it would cost billions of dollars.
You guys, he'll
be by the way, viruses aren't real. Next one.
What? Wait a minute. Nah, I mean, we can't. I don't even know what the fuck to let. Demons and ghosts. I don't know.
Viruses aren't
viruses?
Real, huh?
What?
Yeah, they don't exist.
What are you talking about?
They never isolated them.
What are you talking about?
I ended up in the hospital from COVID for
yeah,
like
but you,
a long
but,
time.
But you think sick. That's COVID. Like, dude, there's a whole bunch of shit going
on. Was it just a cold?
What it is, dude, is that...
You got blown by two Mexicans. What are you thinking? You're not going to come out of that unscathed?
Yeah. You know,
I didn't think it was going to kick in sick? 15 like, years later.
Dude, aren't you afraid to get sick? I got blown by Mexicans. I can survive
in
anything.
In Tijuana.
I wore a mask.
It's called exosome.
You wore a mask?
No,
you
know? I was 25. This is fucking so long ago.
Okay,
here's another COVID one.
Here we go.
COVID was actually being spread through bubble wrap. Companies were putting the disease into bubble wrap, and then when people popped the bubble wrap, they were getting the disease.
I bet you got really proud when you came up with this one.
All right, what do you think?
I think it's real. I think it's real. I think it's probably because they're like, oh, now you have to be at home. You got to use Amazon. It's the only way they can spread it is you fucking, you know, you get your package,
like
you pop it.
I like
so
that.
I think that someone came up with that. That's out there.
I say it's made up because not popping bubble wrap is gay.
Yeah.
If you pop bubble wrap, I mean.
It wouldn't give you COVID. It'd give you full-blown AIDS.
Yeah.
I pop bubble wrap and, you know.
I'm going to say you guys
checks
made
out.
That up.
I do too.
We made that up.
Yeah, 100%. I knew that. Yeah.
Okay. Another one.
This is really hard because
FYI,
anything could be on the internet.
Yeah, exactly.
Here's the thing, though. You know they made both of those up because they put both of their COVID bits together.
Yeah.
Fucking idiots. Separate them.
I thought the opposite. I put them together on purpose to try to trick you guys.
Yeah, like and that's that. Why like you're that. Sitting there and I'm sitting here.
They're just bits.
Asshole.
Helen Keller is not real.
I bet you know the answer to
you
this.
Go, you know. Go. What do you
think? Not real. Yeah, sure. Yeah, it's out there. It's
I'm going to say yeah, too.
I don't know if it's necessary that she's not real, but the story of Helen Keller is complete bullshit. That she was blind, deaf, and mute.
How does she tell the story?
She wrote books and learned languages. Like, what are you talking about?
Well, in your theory, they probably had AI back then.
True.
Yeah, I mean, they could have. Yeah. You know what they think AI is,
she just dictated into Pelosi's tits.
You know what the AI is?
Whoa. Dude, you've already fucked me up three times.
So the story is... Fallen angels came down and mated with the daughters of men and created Nephilim who had angel DNA in them, which means they could live forever. But God put a cap on it. So when they died, their spirits didn't die. Their body just died. So that's what they think ghosts are and all that shit. So they think AI is actually Nephilims.
So that one, that is a... It's a big one.
Are we opening up a portal on the YKWD podcast?
Yeah.
What the fuck? Nephilim?
So, we're definitely on a list now. If we weren't before, we're definitely
so the Helen Keller one's big. Kids on TikTok, no one believes.
We're not on an A list. We're on seven lists.
Yeah.
No one believes it's real, and I have a video of this man on TikTok talking about it. So if you guys put on the headphones, we can watch this. I think it's worth watching.
This guy.
You know what else isn't real? That
this
guy's
is,
gold chain.
This is my go-to source for
I'm going to go to Will Silvint's nephew.
I love that.
It looks like,
look at those chompers. Dude.
Guys, black people co-sign on this.
Helen Keller, you are no. You're exactly how dumb America think we are.
Okay.
Which rock is this?
But write a book, essay. How are you going? How are you even going to fly?
Can't. I can't listen to this guy talk.
This guy can't read and write either. Yeah, but he has a Netflix special coming out.
Yeah. He's one of the great American truth tellers.
He's
gay black. He goes straight to green light.
Yeah, he is. He is at Moon Tower at the Paramount this year with the Helen Keller at bullshit. Ow.
You be right.
All right. What else you got?
Okay, we'll do another one. Dairy Queen is sending 1/8 of their profits through money laundering to an unknown terrorist organization, and in exchange, the organization is using their connections to give them free advertising.
What do you think? You're up.
I think it's bullshit.
Okay, I'm going to think it's real. Because unlike their joke written ones before, that was just quick setup, punch, tag, tag. That was too detailed. He actually read a paragraph on that. I'm going to say that's a real.
I think these guys could write a long, detailed, not funny joke.
Yeah, for sure. <That's possible. laughs>
I'm going to go not real that you guys made that up. Because it would go really deep and you go, what is the front for, why would Dairy Queen be fronting for a terrorist organization? Now, if you study like Toyotas, all the ISIS have Toyotas because Rihanna's boyfriend at the time was selling ISIS Toyotas. But
what? Yeah. Chris Brown?
Yeah, no. After he got, she punched him in the face.
Okay, wait a minute. Who's selling ISIS Toyotas?
So Rihanna dated this Middle Eastern millionaire billionaire.
And he sold Toyotas, not Ferraris?
He sold Toyotas to ISIS. That's why they all had Toyotas.
Really?
They do. Yeah. You do see those pathfinders going through the sand.
I get so jealous because I wanted one. I'm like, these fucking rocket holders are just flying around.
Rocket holders. That's a nice way of saying it. I said towel head in my special. Someone, oh. You blow up buildings, I can call you Towelhead.
Can I say something? When I went to Iraq and we were doing shows over there for the USO, they have the local people would work on the bases in the kitchen and, you know, on the base. And I remember it was raining out one day and one of the guys came in the middle of the show. I'm out front smoking a butt and he came in the front door and he had a towel wrapped around his head. And I went, and he just looked at me and he went, motherfucker, he just took the towel off.
He got it though.
I was like this. I was like, hey. And he was like, motherfucker.
You know what the funniest thing is?
Yeah.
I did a show. It was me, Steve Byrne, Dove Davidoff, and Brian Callen, right?
Yeah.
So Steve's special literally had just dropped. He went to the store that had all the bootlegged fucking movies right there. His special was being bootlegged. Wow. In the Middle East at the time
that's great.
That's crazy, right?
I would tell you, Steve Byrne, after my first album, my Robert Kelly Live album, I put up myself. he sent me a photo. He was in some town. He went to a Salvation Army and he bought 5 of my albums for 50 cents and then threw them out. He took me a video on his phone throwing them out. He's like, good job, Bob.
He's an assassin.
He really is.
So did you make it up or is it real?
Made it up. They had to. Dairy Queen's not successful enough to be involved.
We made up the Dairy Queen.
I should have known that because they're all autistic. Dairy Queen.
Yeah. He said McDonald's or anything else.
God damn it. I should have known Dairy Queen was their favorite little restaurant. Sucking assholes.
Yeah.
You got me.
Princess Diana had an egg fertilized by King Charles to determine whether they could have a couple. It worked.
Have a couple?
To see
if they could have kids.
To see if they could have a kid.
Fucking asshole.
Right? So it worked, but then they went to destroy the embryo, but a doctor kept the embryo and raised it, and now there's a young boy in California that is Princess Diana and King Charles's kid. That's
what?
You guys didn't make that up. That's too deep, too weird.
I even lost half of it. I don't know. Go ahead. You
no, I think that's out on the internet.
I'm going to say that's true. That's a true one.
I could take an L on this one, but I'm going to say that is a made-up story. I mean, there's crazy shit about Princess Di. By the way, her redheaded son is not Prince Charles' kid. There's actually a guy that he looks exactly like, because all these super rich people, they all just cuck each other. They all just pass their wives around, and they all just fucking shoot up the club, you know what I'm saying? And then, like, whoever has a kid. So, like...
I used to think that
Hillary Clinton's kid is not Bill Clinton's kid.
What?
It's actually this Hubbard guy. If you look at their faces, they're exactly the same.
Bring up Chelsea Clinton and Hubbard.
Go put up. Oh, dude, you want to get on a list? I can put something right now.
Let's do it. Put it up.
Obama's kids are not his kids.
Stop it.
100%.
Do you think Michelle this is real, or is this just out there?
No, 100%.
Michelle does not have a penis. You don't believe that, right? Wait, let's wait and see if that's a question.
Quiet.
Stop.
Anything's quiet, right, but Obama's kids are not his kids.
All right, here we go.
Like,
okay, that's two of the same people.
Yeah, who's...
What's that?
Who are these people?
No. Well, I don't know what you're saying here, but if you do...
bring up
what
the,
a mouth.
If you do Chelsea Clinton's real father, you'll look at this Huber guy.
He's only smart in two ways.
Yeah, what is that?
Stand-up comedy and videos.
Yeah.
And then he falls off.
I can't Google.
I mean, he just brought up two of the same photos.
Put up a Barack Obama girl. Okay, there it is. There it is, right there.
Oh my God.
Well, yeah, look at those lips, man. Those are some ugly lips.
Yeah, yeah.
Who was the other guy, though?
It says it right there. Hubler, go up.
What was he?
He was like the Clinton associate, dude. That's how it goes. And then you study, you put in Obama.
I mean,
girl's
when you look at
real
picture.
Parent, and dude, it'll blow. Once you see it, you'll never understand.
You know what one that really got me is Trudeau and Fidel.
Yeah, 100%.
Bring up Trudeau and Fidel Castro. I mean, they look exactly alike. And his mom used to hang out with
him. Oh, yeah. She was, dude, I'm telling you, they just pass each other around.
But here, can I just say something about that?
You could say anything you want.
If we were rich millionaires,
yeah,
we do the same thing.
Yeah.
I mean, look, we were in Vegas for a weekend. We were doing some weird shit.
Yeah.
We were hundredaires. Imagine if we were gazillionaires, dude. You know how many kids I'd have that look like you?
Did you ever hook up with a hundredaire before?
Did you bring up Trudeau and... No, of course not, right, Danny? Okay.
The internet just goes down.
I mean, no, that's not it. He stinks.
Yeah.
Bring up... I can't. I can't. Bring up Trudeau looks like Fidel, and that will come up.
Go Trudeau's real father.
Yeah, I mean...
Oh, here we go. No, that's it. Down one, over one. There you go. Click that. That's it. Yes, that's the one you want to look at.
Oh, they got the eyebrows.
Yeah. Yeah.
Hang on, he's going to make...
Come on, you autistic fuck. Here we go.
Here we go. Yeah, I mean, dude.
Look at that, dude. I mean, 100%.
I mean, Jesus Christ.
Yeah,
that's
it's
crazy.
Not even close. And then you look who they think it's his dad.
Yeah, look at his real dad. It looks like Jim Norton.
Yeah. 100%.
Anyways, okay, so what's...
Don't do the Obama daughters, because... You guys aren't ready for that.
Why? What are you talking about?
I'm ready for that.
All right, let me
I would
see.
Like to
are
see
we,
that.
Are we really going to get in trouble?
No.
All right, okay, go ahead. Play
put,
Obama.
Put real Obama daughter's real parents. Put in that and you'll see it.
Is it the gay guys from Modern Family?
Well, do you know, dude?
Hey.
Well, what's very interesting is the older Obama daughter has decided to drop her last name.
Really?
Yeah, she's dropped her last name.
Why?
Nobody knows.
Stop it.
Nobody knows.
No.
100%.
Maybe she doesn't want to get recognized.
Dude, if she walked in, you go, holy shit, it's the Obama
daughter. I actually wouldn't I wouldn't know.
You got it?
Oh, no. But yeah, go find the real. Go find them. There's one.
Maybe
of
a picture
together.
Of the kids next to him.
Yeah, they have one. Just go Obama real daughter.
He doesn't listen because his autism makes him, I'm right, you're wrong.
You know what he's like?
Yeah, an asshole.
No. Have you ever done
fucking
stand-up in China?
Asshole.
You know why? Have you ever done stand-up in China?
No.
So you go there, you notice that everyone's Asian and there's no car wrecks.
Mm-hmm.
You would think it would be like fucking bumper cars with all the Asians there.
Yeah.
So I've decided that Asians aren't bad drivers. They're just so advanced. Our driving fucks them up.
Really?
That's what's going on. He's autistic. He's so beyond us.
Yeah.
That our stupidness
yeah.
Makes him fuck up.
Right. He's showing us what we should be looking at.
Yeah. Obama, go down.
That other photo he got.
Okay, yeah. Click that. Let me see that one right there. Down, over. Click.
Oh, you're an idiot. You're an
idiot.
That one.
Click.
You know which one he wants.
Okay. Okay, click that, then go down. Oh, yeah, no, it's right there. Click that. Nope, down. That one.
I'm going to throw up.
Click that one.
I'm going to throw up.
There we go. Look at this
Oh,
one.
God, this is like Rain Man. I can't. When he was playing the cards. Queens. Yeah, a lot of queens.
Look at this.
What?
That is, on the right is what they say is their parents, and then on the left is this mystery couple that's always seen with the Obamas.
I don't know about this one.
Let me ask this then.
You don't think that one side looks way more like the girls than the other side? Come on, dude. You're just saying all black people look alike. That's what you're saying.
I'm not
Andrew.
Saying that.
That looks like a.
I let you say that.
That looks.
I held my tongue.
That looks like a sitcom in the 90s on Fox.
ABC's Who's the Parents?
That's a good show.
Yeah.
So you're saying that they're not the parents.
Yes.
Because there's another rumor that there's no pregnant photos of.
Yeah, that's true. They're gay.
Who's gay?
So we've had.
Who's gay?
The kids or the parents?
The parents.
The Obamas are gay.
So Obama's definitely gay. And it like.
What?
Since JFK, we've had.
Do you think Biden sucked his dick?
We've had two.
I know he's gay.
We've had two gay. We've had two gay presidents. Since Obama, we've had one straight president, two straight presidents, two gay presidents, and two Andy Dick presidents.
What does that mean?
Really gay.
That would just
that's alcoholic
that
gay.
That would fuck anything. Like you in Mexico. That would just fuck anything, gotcha. Right?
God damn it.
So JFK and Clinton were both bisexual. George Bush Sr. and Obama, gay. And then Jimmy Carter and George Bush Jr., straight.
Dude, my head's
gonna
explode.
Dude, who let a cockatoo in, by the way? Listen to that. Who's mating right now? What animal is mating?
It's the only thing that's keeping me from going in the light. Is that fucking weird laugh right now. Please.
Let's bring you back to reality.
I mean, what? Do you have any more?
Yeah, we have a couple more. Or we have one more.
All right, one more.
David Bowie is an alien and did not die. He left Earth and returned to his home planet in 2016.
There's no aliens. I go ahead.
I think you guys made that up.
You made it up. It's real, but it's bullshit. It's bullshit because if Sam is telling the truth,
yeah,
there's only demons and angels. There's no aliens. There's no place to go.
Yes. Right? There's so, dimensions.
There's dimension. What?
There's dimensions.
I'm gonna throw up.
Okay.
Go ahead. That's too much.
So so I believe that his like alter ego was Iggy Stardust, right? Is that what it was? And like, so there's this whole belief that like, yeah, he was an alien somewhere. I don't think it's real, but I think you got, dude, I'm so in trouble, right? This might be the one that gets me because there is a discussion about that. But I, at the same time, I think you guys made it up.
That one was made up, but it was also made up by your producer guy who helped us to trick you with some.
Okay, perfect.
So that one was made up to trick you.
Okay, true. Yeah, so I batted 1,000.
So you don't believe, now I just went to, you don't believe in that we went to the moon?
No, we didn't.
Okay.
Okay, will you look up
Do you
one
think
thing?
The word, please tell me this.
Look up this, one thing. Look up, go to YouTube, put in astronauts leaving the moon. I want you to watch this, and you tell me if you think this is real.
Okay, I'm going to bring that up. Make sure you bring it up off screen, and then put it on screen so we don't have to tediously watch you fumble.
There was that video that just came out where, what's his name, tried to fight a guy who-
Buzz Aldrin?
Yeah.
But here's also weird about that. Is like there are interviews where Buzz Aldrin basically tells like a small girl and Conan O'Brien in another interview that we never went to the moon.
Okay, stop.
No, I got one that will blow your mind.
So is the Earth flat? Please tell me you don't think that.
Buddy, I don't know what it is. Do you know who invented the heliocentric model?
No.
Helio Estevez?
The Jesuit order. Now, if you study what they believe, this is going to get weird and I'm going to lose everybody again, but what the flat earth people believe is that we live on a plane.
Bring that mic up to you.
Okay, with that we live on a plane. Okay, here, I want you to watch this real quick, and then we'll get into that. So, okay, here we go. So this is them telling you this is how we left the moon. Ready? Watch this.
99, proceeded, 3, 2, 1, ignition.
Okay, so.
Houston, bet you're good.
Yeah, look at his shit. Look at that. Okay. Okay, couple questions. Where's the jet propulsion? How is there fire in space when there's no oxygen? And how is the guy following? Who's following the it going up? Who is
working? Can I explain it to you?
Oh, please.
I want to explain it to you.
Okay.
I just saw a spacewalk.
Oh.
Okay.
Okay.
There was a spacewalk where guys, and they had the same thing.
Okay.
I believe.
All right.
That. This is just a theory of mine that they reenacted what really happened because they couldn't show us. They wanted to show us what was happening up there, right? The guy opened the thing. I just went to the Kennedy Space Station. I watched all this stuff. I saw the astronauts talking about the spacewalk, and it's like, oh, that's bullshit. I watched the video. But I think they reenacted these things to give you this is what it looked like when we did it. We couldn't get video of it, but if we could have at the time, this is what it looked like.
Okay.
Because now, if you look at space video, space walks or stuff from the International Space, you don't believe in the International Space Station. It's not up there.
Do you remember?
I almost cried at the Atlantis space shuttle little video. It made me tear up.
Right. I'm going to drop on something that will blow your mind. I'm telling you, you're going to think, you think I'm nuts now. Wait till I tell you my favorite conspiracy.
Oh, good.
But will you look up the launching of the International Space Station, and we'll sit here for 1,000 years because it doesn't exist. There's no
because
footage.
You're kind of being a hypocrite.
No, I'm not.
I'll tell you why.
Why?
Because we had cars and fucking electricity hundreds of years ago, but we can't put something up in space.
True. Yeah, but buddy.
Thanks.
But buddy.
I'm with you.
Thanks.
That's right.
But no.
I mean, we're just stuck here?
Yeah.
Why? They had fucking shit hundreds of years ago. We had a whole civilization.
God created the above and below, and he created something that
Can you bring the mic up a bit?
Okay. God created something that detached, that separated the waters from above.
Thank you.
From the waters below.
Hang on 1 second. Thanks for doing that 2 hours into the show. I hate all three of you. I hope you all
was
get
it that
anal
bad, though? I feel like I'm yelling
good.
All the
you
time.
You were good.
No, it was good, but.
No, dude. Okay, let's watch it.
Yeah, there it is.
There it is. No?
That's it. They put it up in pieces, though. That's why they developed.
I'm telling you,
they
bro.
Developed the space shuttle.
And, you know, I'll take an L on that if that's real.
They developed the space shuttle to bring things up there to
buddy,
make.
Buddy, I'm telling you right now, if you study the trajectory of rockets, that
I
don't
saw
go into space,
a rocket.
How do you have the time?
I saw a rocket. I was just in Cocoa Beach. I saw a rocket leave the Earth.
Oh, you saw it leave the Earth, Rob? Or did you see it go up in the air and then it slowly go? I'm telling you, bro, they can't.
It landed.
They can't get it through the Van Allen belt, dog. They can't do it.
Gary Van Allen?
Yeah. Yeah, he played.
From Secor Road?
No, he's in Van Halen and he played the fucking tambourine and they kicked him out.
Frequencies.
I'm just telling you, bro.
Okay, well.
They can't get past it.
Wow,
so are you ready for the craziest idea?
Yeah, what is this?
You ready for the craziest one?
Crazier than the Chicago house?
Yeah, yeah.
Crazier than
the craziest one.
Crazier than the gay,
it's so
gay Obamas.
Nuts. The Obamas are gay, but
crazier than Bill
bisexual.
Clinton and Kennedy being bisexual.
They were totally bisexual.
Okay, go ahead. I don't not believe anything you're saying.
He was a tweaker, bro, and he just wanted to stick dicks in holes.
You talking about
JFK,
Danny, or
JFK.
Are you talking about who? Are you talking
JFK.
About JFK.
He was a tweaker. He did Chris. He did speed.
Wow, this is crazy.
Right.
Okay, tell me the craziest thing ever.
Okay. The craziest story
I want you to say that to my mother about JFK. She's from Boston, Irish Catholic. She'll slap your face.
I know, bro.
How dare you say that about Johnny?
Yeah. They're like, it's like the black community with Tupac.
He really is, dude.
Okay. That the astronauts on the Challenger didn't die.
Oof.
Okay, now I'm going to say something to you.
Okay.
I think I was in second grade.
Yes.
And they brought the TV
in.
No,
you were, it was old. It was later.
I think
if we're the same, we're on the same age, you were much older.
Maybe four.
No, you were like in eighth grade.
Was not.
Yes.
What year was it?
I think, what year did the space shuttle blow up? Yeah, you were in. You had to be in eighth or
what,
tenth.
What year was it?
You were much older.
We're going to find out. It's math.
Yeah.
So stop conspiracy theorying my life. All right? I know when I was at. When?
1986.
86.
86.
So you were not. You were dumb, but you were in. You were 14 in second grade.
I was actually 16, and I was in rehab. So I have an excuse. I just got done using drugs.
Was that then?
Yeah.
Are you sure? Why did I think the chat?
That's so funny.
I want to say something.
Yeah.
This is why I don't not believe anything you're saying.
Oh, yeah.
I have a memory of watching the space shuttle blow up in second grade. When was the first space shuttle launched? Maybe I mixed the two up. Maybe I did that. That's why you can't not believe anybody.
Sorry.
When was this first space shuttle? You have a computer.
1981.
81. I was, I was 11. So again, I'm wrong on that. It was not second grade. Second grade is, wow. Maybe I never went to fucking jail.
Dude.
Maybe I was
Mandela
never molested.
Mandela effect. Everything's on different timelines.
What, the old black guy?
Yeah, but there's something called the Mandela effect, which is that...
It's like the Berenstain Bears thing.
Yeah, we
situation.
Keep changing timelines, so our stories are different.
Fuck. This is getting crazy.
Okay.
I'm quitting podcasting.
So I'm with you, dude. I'm sorry. We'll stop. But if you ever get a chance, study.
Tell me what this
is. So we're going to start off with something called Operation Northwoods, right? Operation Northwoods was an attempt by the CIA to draw the United States into war with Cuba. So what they wanted to do, and this made the JFK's table. They wanted to do this, okay, where they started to... They were going to fake this music festival in Cuba, and that they were going to do this big media blitz about these college kids were going to go to Cuba to be in this festival. And these college kids were probably all CIA plants, and they were on the news, and they were this is what they proposed. They were going to go on the news, do a big, giant media blitz like Andrew's doing for his special, right? He's going everywhere. He's telling everybody about
What's the name of it again?
I'm not doing that again.
Come on. What is it?
March 28th. I'll tell you this.
Say it.
So,
say it again, dude. Push
can't
it.
Can't do it. Okay. I'll tell you this. Come on.
Okay, there we go. So they were going to do this big media blitz, right? And then the day they were going to have a day where all the press shows up to them. They're waving at everybody to get on the plane. They're going to put the plane in the air, okay? Then while it was out of sight, they were going to land it, okay?
Yeah.
And then they were going to put another plane in the sky and blow it up. And then they were going to make it seem like it was Cuba that blew up the plane so they could find a reason to go into war with Cuba. Well, JFK read it and he's like, no, we're not doing that. I'm not down with that at all. So if you study the Challenger blowing up, it is step by step the exact same thing. It is that, oh, we're going to send this teacher into space. She does all the press everywhere. Everyone's like, oh, yeah, I'm going to go into space. It's fucking crazy. It's nuts. You interview all these people. And then the big day shows up and everyone's like, the teacher's going into space. So you see him getting on the rocket, right? And then it goes in, boom, explodes. You go, well, where did they go? Well, people don't know that under the space shuttle is a room called the rubber room. And it's this.
That's where I was in junior high.
Yeah, you were in NASA, yeah. Dude. So this underground slide brings you to this rubber room that's below.
Wait a minute, stop. They don't have stairs?
No, they have a slide because you want to get out of there quick it's meant to be if like something goes bad on the plane.
Right. Okay.
So then they did. So this happens before the internet. So once something's out of the news, everyone moves on. You can find every single person that was supposed to be on that flight, you can find him in real day, except for one guy. Everybody else. You could look it up, dude.
Okay, Danny, look up
Challenger astronaut still alive.
Okay, look that up. And now
they have
I'm gonna confront you on this. Okay? I'm gonna do this back.
Okay.
I don't know if
we're doing a lot of karate chop.
I don't know if this is we're in the dojo.
Yeah.
Listen, what I wanna say is this.
Yes.
The Cuba thing.
Yeah.
I understand the reasoning for them wanting to do that. They wanted to go into Cuba and start a war with them because communism was on our doorstep.
Yes.
What the hell would the reasoning be for this? Listen to me. What would the reasoning be for doing this? It may for what?
Well, okay, now we're getting into something totally different, which is that the world is ran by fucking sorcerers. There it is. Click that gray one. That one. So
guys, stop. Stop. He just used the word sorcerer.
The world is ran by sorcery.
All right, listen, is there a ring in this story?
Well, it is kind of like fucking Lord of the Rings, but it is. So this is it, dude. Hey, that's because he had to blow it up. It's really, really shitty ass.
That's the Obama kid's real dad. that's Arthur Fronzarelli.
But if you see the guy,
that's the Karate Kid, dude.
Yeah. So what happens is the black guy, the Asian guy, what they tell you is that the guys in the bubble are their twin brothers, but there's no record of them having twins. The woman at the top, right? She is in law. She teaches like law at like Harvard. She has the same mannerisms and the same lip.
What's her
the
name?
Guy at the bottom in the with the big chin has the exact same name as the guy. The guy in the middle has the exact same name and the same eyes.
No
it's
way.
All real, dude.
Doesn't have the same name.
Yes, he does. I mean,
they fucking did all of this, made a slide, took him out, blew up a ship, and they were like,
bro,
we got the name.
Bro, because
we
there
got
was
the
no,
fucking name. We should have named
him
no Greg.
Internet at the time.
What?
There's no internet at the time. So there was nobody who was going to check.
But didn't they know an internet was going to come?
A month later, everyone's moved on, like in terms of who was on the shuttle.
There's not somebody at the Winn-Dixie going, yo, man, you look just like the
Winn-Dixie?
Dude. You look like the dude who just got blown up.
The Winn-Dixie, the Snopes of like 1980s?
The Winn-Dixie is a fucking supermarket in Florida.
No, nobody remembered those fucking. They've all moved on. They're like, I'm the twin. And literally.
Is there interviews of these people saying that? Are there video of these people saying I'm a twin?
Yeah.
No
yeah.
way.
Yeah, they interview them like, yeah, I'm his twin.
Okay. So why did they do it? I know why they did it back in the day.
Two reasons. One,
yeah.
It's all about trauma.
Okay.
Traumatizing people because these lizard people feed off our negative energy and our depression.
One
okay?
second. Sam, I love
and
you.
And the
just
second
give me,
thing.
Give me one second.
Okay.
One second. Just hold on for one second.
Yeah.
Yo, dude, I think he said lizard people.
Oh, yeah. No, I heard it. I've heard lizard people before. Yeah. I had a conversation with someone about lizard people yesterday.
Yeah.
Weirdly enough.
They're descendants of the Anunnaki.
Oh, God. What's happening? Wait a minute, dude. I'm so fucked.
Yeah. The lizard people's the whole... I mean, that's the whole thing.
Can I ask you a question?
Yes.
Are magicians sorcerers?
No, like David Copperfield? No, yeah. Dude. That's just gay
dudes. What about David Blaine?
Just gay dudes?
Yeah, they're just gay dudes.
Okay, thanks. Thanks.
Doing butt stuff.
Okay, great. Because Danny and Joe were...
But sorcerers,
magicians.
It's like... If you even study like 9/11, right? All the numbers associated with it are connected to this thing called this religion or belief called Thelema. They're all the same number.
Are you? Can I say something?
But I'm the happiest I've ever been.
Your brain must be it just.
This
you must
is,
be
no,
exhausted.
But once you see it, no, it's not. It's really simple.
Well, let me ask you a question.
You go through this kind of cycle.
Are you? Like
okay.
I'm tired just riding a bike with my son.
Yeah.
If I had to think about the sorcerers and the lizard people, and then I would be like, it'd be so exhausting.
Right.
But like, once you go down this hole, and then you have to like be challenged all the time about this stuff because everybody's whatever them in the matrix, right? And then they have to challenge you.
They just
want to
eat steak.
They just want to eat steak, right? Which I'm fine with.
Yeah,
I
get it. I love steak.
But you have all this stuff in your head about what's really going on. Why isn't someone just taking you out? Why aren't these people after you?
Because one, it's not you just can't take somebody out. It's like it's a very
they just
big
deal. They fucking blew up a ship.
I feel like they could take you up pretty easily.
Well, I mean, like I'm a dick joke comic. Mm-hmm. Like I don't
You're
break news. I just like right. report like what is out there.
Okay.
So I don't like go, hey man, here's this story that's gonna bring down the empire. I don't do
what is your what I want to know your favorite conspiracy theory.
That is it.
This is
it. But also that the world is ran by sorcerers. That's it.
It's all black magic.
Is there a,
there's no religion.
Do you,
sorry to the Jews, but there's no religion.
Do we know runs any?
It. It's like deep, deep, deep what?
Do we know any sorcerers, or these are like in the background, we'll never know? Like, you,
if you,
you
know their like, names, they don't like the people who actually run the world are Babylonian bankers that go way beyond Abrahamic religions. They go all the way back to Babylon and all that stuff, and they're called the Black Nobility.
I went to Babylon.
Yeah.
I went to Abraham's home.
Did you?
And I climbed to the top of the ziggurat. Yeah,
actually, I don't even know if that's real, but I respect that.
No, the ziggurat is like a little pyramid there.
Is that with the dogs where they hush, they go through the... through Alaska.
That's the Iditarod.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. See? I'm doing puns, bro.
I mean, dude, so JFK was killed by the CIA for being gay.
Like, I heard it could be a lot of different
He was
ways.
Killed by a bunch. It was like when you watch JFK Mafia, go through maybe. There, it's like, it's literally like a scene from John Wick when he's in like the plaza and all the phones go off. Everybody there is an assassin. He couldn't get out of there. They had to take him out.
Why?
Because he was, it's a lot of stuff, and I don't want to get too deep into it, but there's a lot. He was going after all the people you don't go after.
Yeah. I've been to there a bunch of times, and I've talked to like guys who hold up signs and like, you want to hear what really happened? And I've like talked to those guys, and there's like the Mafia wanted to get him, the KKK wanted to get him, and then the CIA, like
there's
everybody wanted to get him. There's no real like answer.
So why isn't somebody, why aren't they killing Trump? If that's the case, this guy comes in, he's a billionaire, self-made, doesn't need that money, goes against everything, fucks the whole system up.
Does he? I mean, like, dude, Trump is just, you know what Trump is to me? A different crime organization. Like, for the longest time, I called the George Bush death cult's been running everything.
Right.
I think Trump represents a different organization. I call it New York City Real Estate, which is super corrupt and super, they want to get in on the, you remember from Brewster's Millions when he decides to run for mayor of Chicago and the two guys running are both super corrupt? Mm. That's what the president is. You're just in charge of giving out all the fucking... handing out all the contracts you want handed to your boys.
Right.
So it's just a different, and sometimes they work together and sometimes they go to war with each other.
And that's what's happening.
To me, Trump is Godzilla. Okay. And Trump to me is Godzilla. And it's like, yeah, he fucked up Tokyo at one point, but now there's bigger monsters coming in and he might be our only hope.
And who is Biden?
Biden is Rodan.
He's a dying gorilla.
Yeah, he's like the ones with the, he's like the three, it's like Obama, Hillary Clinton, Joe Biden, the three, you know, the three-headed dragon.
Yeah, fuck.
Three-headed dragon.
Yeah.
And that's it? You don't know.
Is it Rodan? No, I know.
Whatever
his name
is? No, it was Rodan. Yeah, it was Rodan.
It feels like more of a Mothra.
Maybe it could be,
Mothra
goes was towards a good the guy, though. Mothra was a good guy.
Oh, yeah, I don't remember who was good or bad. Good. I thought Godzilla was the only good one.
Godzilla was his origin story was a bad guy.
Yeah.
And then he like they realize, oh fuck, there's even worse out there. We need him.
There's so much to talk to you guy about, dude. I mean, there's so many. there's so much. I mean, dude, it's so much stuff. And when you get into it, it's scary because if you know the truth about stuff, you might want to try to change things.
Well, you
and
start
that's
with
exhausting.
That. But then you get to a point where you realize that nobody's come to save you and you got to save yourself, and then it gets really empowering.
But what do you do about all this? You tell everybody about it.
Well, I mean, like what do you do? There's an old saying, like, don't worry about the sheep, wake up the sleeping lions. And I'm like, fuck the sleeping lions. Don't wake up anybody. And, you know, just put out the information. Those who want to wake up, take care of you, take care of your family. Nobody's come to save you. Nobody's come to save you. It's just like, you got to save yourself. And then you get a whole bunch of like-minded people together. And that's how you do something. Like, dude, if after all this crazy shit, you still don't believe in conspiracies, then I can't help. It's like the prophet Eddie Bravo used to say. Like, if you, after all this crazy ass shit, you don't think in elites conspire at the basic, elites conspire. Then I can't save you. And you just got, you're on your own.
I believe that, but I do believe 100%. we did go into space.
That's fine. Everybody's got something that they want to
believe. And I
believe
the earth is round.
You're allowed to.
You believe the earth is flat?
Let me just finish my thought.
It's early. A dimensional
plane.
So
they believe we lived on a plane. The Jesuit order, which is the Vatican.
Yeah.
They had a Jesuit priest.
Are you calling the Pope a Jew?
No, he's a Jesuit.
Okay.
The Jesuit order.
Yeah.
Okay. Which
which is, do you know what the Jesuit logo is?
What?
A giant T.
Okay.
Because it goes back to
he's
the
trans?
Knights of Temple. But it's a giant T. So what we were taught at one point is that the earth is on a plane.
Okay.
And then a Jesuit priest came and said, oh no, we go around the sun. So then they took the Jesuit T and they put it at the end of plane, and now we got planet. So it's like, it's right there. Like, and he didn't even want to put it out, the Jesuit priest. On his deathbed, the Vatican's like, guess what? We're putting out your book. He's like, no. And he went out, dog. So it's super interesting.
What do you do when you have all this information, though, right? Like, you're throwing down so much on us. Like, what do you do with that info besides share it? Like, what, you know, you just take care of your family, but what do you?
I learned jujitsu, Krav Maga. I just buy gold and silver, and then I buy crypto, and I just chill, and I just enjoy the journey.
Should I be buying crypto?
Crypto's weird, man. I can get you into this guy that's helped me just buy. I just told him to buy the coin, but.
Which one should I buy?
It's called, I bought it. It's at a low thing. I'm going to tell you guys right now. This is not legal advice. This is not economic advice. Invest at your own, and I wouldn't listen to me. I'm retarded.
but saying that, all this put $15,000 in this.
Node AI is what I bought, but Node I'm going to be working with my friend James, who is, I got a couple people I work with.
Is that a stock or is that a crypto?
That's a crypto.
And
but let me tell you, do you know Howie Dewey?
I know Howie Mandel.
Howie Dewey.
Howdy Dewey.
Very funny comic.
I don't.
This is Howie Dewey.
He told this me to buy. You want to get in the stock? Look into Uber. I'm telling you, dude, because he said Uber is like $60, $70 pop. Yeah. All of his friends on Wall Street say this is easily a $300, $400 stock at one point because they're trying to get into like Amazon shit. Where they want to ship everything everywhere. You can order
you have
food.
Groceries yep, and yep, all that yep. stuff.
Uber yeah. is the play right
I
now.
I use it a lot.
Not financial advice.
So buy Uber stock.
Buy Uber stock.
And buy the other thing. What about
gold? Listen,
what about gold
Bobby,
and silver?
Buy gold and silver.
Why?
Load up on it.
What, just buy
because,
it and keep
because
it in my house?
With inflation, with them printing money, like all the problems in our country are based on the Federal Reserve.
But it's so high right now, right?
But it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. Buy like, dude, buy some gold and then just buy a bunch of silver. Because if everything
collapsed, where do you buy it?
Oh, you know where you go? You go to samtripoli.com. You click on the banner. It says Wise Wolf Gold and Silver, and you can join their Wolf Pack. And they send you monthly. They send you gold and silver. But I buy gold and silver from Wise Wolf Gold and Silver.
Hmm. Well, can they? Can I have?
And they'll ship it to you.
Will they ship it to? Is it good though? Is it real?
It's yeah, it's real. Dude, why would I come on your show and push?
I don't know, dude. You told
gold.
Me there's lizards people.
Yeah,
everybody's gay.
No, I said some are bisexual.
Okay, yeah. All right, Liz, we got to wrap this up, dude. I knew this was gonna be a good one.
I love you, Ryan.
I love you too, buddy. Okay, Sam, where can people find your dates? Come see you.
Go to samtripoli.com. I got Comedy Chaos. If you're ever in LA on a Tuesday and I got a show, tell me. I would love for you to both of you guys.
I'm coming out there. I'm coming out there. Me and Jay, I believe, for that Netflix thing.
Yeah.
To do the bonfire.
Hit me up.
You got to come on the show. You got to come on bonfire.
I would love that. I love Big Jay. He's so fucking fast. All you guys are so fucking fast. I got this. When does this come out?
A few weeks.
Okay. So hopefully by then. But just go to samtribute.com for all of my dates. I also, and you can check me out. I got a podcast called Tinfoil Hat. Broken Simulation is my comedy podcast. Cash Daddies is my financial podcast. And then if you go to Rumble, I'm doing a show called Doom Scrolling. But just go on samtribute.com. You can find it all.
Awesome.
The special, I'll tell you this, Mark Norman's YouTube, March 28th. It should be out now, I think.
Yeah.
And follow me at No Young Blood on Instagram and all that shit. And I got a podcast called The Mess Hall where I give horrible advice to people. Please check all that out. And then the Riot Comedy Festival is probably next week, I guess.
I'm there. We'll be there together.
We'll be there. It'll be fun.
Yeah, that's
congrats,
awesome.
Dude.
I'm doing a live podcast. I'm doing a couple sets, and then I got my own show called Trash Flavored Trash.
I love that name, dude.
Yeah, I love it too.
So make sure you check out Andrew's special. Go there right now, like it and share it,
please,
and spread the word. And of course, Tizzy 3, what do you got?
Max Marcus Comedy, all social media.
at Danny Braff on Instagram, and I'll be opening for Bobby in Boston, and I'll also be at the Dojo Comedy with Jeremiah Watkins on March 28th.
Don't ever plug somebody else's dates on my show. All right? You plug your own dates.
And then for everything Joe Russell, go to The Cheese Show on YouTube. Just type in The Cheese Show.
And we're going to be starting a GoFundMe for Joe's sinuses so he doesn't sound like that anymore. And of course, check out the Dojo Comedy Club, man. One of the best clubs. I'm so glad that you guys did it.
Thank you.
And it's out there in Jersey, man. And it's I love alternatives because it makes everybody keep their shit in check.
Yes.
Because once somebody does it right, and people are like, I'm just gonna go over here, it's just better. Then other people might have to get their shit together.
And then, Bobby, your tour dates. Bobby, you can see Bobby in Houston, Texas at the Riot Comedy Festival, Austin, Texas at the Comedy Mothership,
nice.
San Antonio at Laugh Out Loud, Lafayette, Louisiana, Boston, Massachusetts, Sarasota, Atlanta, Georgia, all over. Check it out more at robertkellylive.com.
Thank you, Danny. This has been a great show.
I love you,
blast,
buddy.
Man. I left my family on a Sunday for this.
Thank you, buddy. And I'm so happy I got to do your
show. And I will see you in L.A.
Yeah.
And I'm glad we hung out. Great episode. Hope you enjoyed it. Make sure you go to the patreon.com/Robert Kelly. We have questions that are going up there for these guys. Real quick, we're going to do that. And that's where you can find those questions. The extra little thing, we have the extra episode. You get to watch the show live, all on patreon.com/Robert Kelly. We're going there right now. You guys are the best fans in the world. We'll see you next time. You know what, dude?
You've been listening to the YKWD podcast. Thanks for listening. Now go back to your shitty jobs.